Hey guys, Fabulous here today, and welcome to part 50 of City Skylines. Yes, we made it all the way to number 50. That's pretty incredible. I'm not quite sure why we got a high crime rate there. That's interesting. Our crime rate is 13%. No, I guess we could use a police station around there. Anyways, that's the least of our problems right now. Between episodes, literally just then, actually. First of all, I fixed up the train line because a lot of people were very upset about that. There was a few, one or two comments down below that were mentioning it. I fixed that up. You may also notice that I also added a highway going the opposite direction because what ended up happening, essentially what the problem is here, is that we have loads of high density commercial in this area and offices and commercial down there as well. And basically this industry area is essentially feeding this office area. And because we also have, whatever this is. Also, I've noticed that this is happening quite frequently now. Like the district names are disappearing. Like you can't see it, but if we just enter. Wait, no, it goes. Oh, no. Space, enter. Yeah, now you can see it. Okay. Anyways, yeah. So we have industrial space planning, which doubles the amount of trucks and vehicles that come out of this industrial area. So therefore, not only do we already have a lot of trucks leaving this area, but we've got double that amount of normal. So then we have all those trucks leaving this area. And the other thing you may note is in here in Hemlock Heights, we have small business benefactor. No, actually over here, small business enthusiast and big business benefactor. Now that doubles the amount of income they produce or something, but also doubles the amount of resources and everything they need. So essentially we've created an area between these two sections that needs loads of traffic, loads of deliveries, all that kind of stuff. And they were all using this main road here in the Vast Deference Heights, and they had to go through this intersection, then they had to go through an intersection here and one there. So that it created a real big problem. Also down this road, there's a ton of intersections. So I added the second highway coming in down this way. I readjusted this road. This road used to go straight across, straight to there. But that wasn't working because they still had to go through two intersections, and that was messy. So instead, I've just connected the road directly up to the highways, obviously with the exception of this road passing through it. So they can now get into that area just fine. And it seems to work. I mean, we've still got a bit of traffic, but of course that's always to be expected, but they can get into the area how they like. I also added a small connecting road here because initially they could only get to the area through the avenue, but I think just allowing traffic to go that way as well is going to be helpful. Now, we're pretty good as a city overall. We've got a lot of industrial demand, so we're going to look at that soon. A little bit of backup there. So I've turned despawning off, obviously. Now, one, I did notice one very, very big problem, and you'll see it in just a second. Oh, there. Do you see it? Do you see the really big problem we're having right now? All of those roads are red, and we've got loads of dead people because nobody can. Like, it is 100% gridlock around here. Nothing is moving. I noticed this, and I was like, hang on, what is causing this? Because it's not this area. It's not these guys because they're part of the problem. It's the bloody roundabout. I have no doubt it's the roundabout because everybody that's backed up are going toward the roundabout. It moves every so often, but there's just too much traffic for this roundabout to handle. We just can't have it anymore. As you can see, everybody's dying around the if you live near a roundabout, you will die. So we need to get rid of this. It cannot be a roundabout anymore. So we need to make sure there are bus lines going here. So we need to essentially connect everything back up just with an intersection. So this is going to go straight across. Now this is going to probably be very messy. Does that need to connect? Are there bus lines that go through the roundabout there? I think there are. Bus lines. Actually, no, they don't. I mean, they might used to. Hang on, let's have a look. Bus lines. So this, I don't think these ever did. Maybe they didn't. I should have checked it before. It's still there. You can still see them. Okay, no, that's fine. We don't actually need to connect that road up, which I'm not going to because that's just going to create unnecessary traffic. We do need to connect that one up, and we do need to connect that overpass because a lot of people use that. So that's actually not as bad as I thought it was going to be. Now, that's going to come straight through there. I'm going to adjust that little overpass road. That will probably go there. I mean, obviously it can't because it's not working. Hang on, let's turn off snapping real quick. No, turn off snapping. Oh, I think we had it on floating is probably why. Yeah, there we go. So we can connect it up there or to that one. Now, that's technically not an intersection yet, so I guess I don't want to add traffic to it. I would like to connect up to that one, but I can't, can I? Okay. Well, why don't we get rid of that bit? Get out of my way. Let's go straight in like that. And then maybe we'll just connect this section up to that road. Because there's no reason it has to be connected up to that intersection. There's no bus lines that go down there, I don't think. Let's have a look. No, there's nothing there. So this could easily just be connected up to that dead-end road there and prevent another intersection that we don't need. So if this... Hang on, snapping back on. Goes around. Connects on there. So to get into that area, they do have to drive all the way around now. But I think that will make our problems a little bit better. Look at all the cars stuck there. So we do have traffic lights there now, but let's wait for the traffic to all start moving. So I'm going to keep... I mean, I could just clear the traffic, but I want to see if this simulation starts going, if we start solving the problem. Actually, no. We have vehicles that are legitimately just glitched out, so maybe I will actually just clear traffic. Okay. So we've cleared it. Obviously, we have to wait a little while for the traffic to build up again. We'll see how we go. We're getting crime problems because nobody can get to this whole area was 100% gridlocked. That was awful. Okay, so now that we solved that problem, well, hopefully have solved that problem. We'll have to wait and see how it goes. We're getting good issues and death and garbage piling up all around there. So that's not good. That did not end well. And I think I've solved or at least helped out the issue over there. We are ready to continue working on the city. So that's almost empty, 13% full. So we can, hopefully, I want to try and redevelop this area throughout the episode. I guess what we do need to do is get rid of all the hospitals we have. Well, we don't need to. I'm just going to leave them. I can't be bothered. There's so many of them. We don't really need to. I mean, we don't need them, but there's no point in removing them either. So we'll just, well, whatever. I want to redevelop that, but not just yet, because we need more industry. I was thinking, I want to do it out here, even though it's quite far away. This is all fertile ground, so we can do a bunch of farms out here. So I'm thinking we might even just use a single highway road that will obviously connect up to that highway. Let's have a look. So let's go from, it's kind of like what we did over all the way over here where we have just a single road going through. I don't know if I ever showed this because I know I cut it out. The reason I cut that out is I literally spent like 20 minutes doing that. And I was barely talking. I was just like, okay, that's good. That was just really boring, so cut that out. Yeah, no, I think if we do that, because I don't think we're going to need a full highway. Oh, look at all the traffic coming in. That's all good. So if we go from about here, I'd rather the train line bridge. Actually, I'm just going to get rid of the rest of this train line here, because this doesn't go anywhere, because we have that glitched out train outside of the borders, so that's completely useless, that railway. So let's get rid of that section. So we won't even need to bridge it because what we'll use this. We will connect this up to this industrial area. Or maybe even that one over there. Maybe we'll just get rid of this little appendix because we don't need that. And then I'll neaten up that corner because that could be a little bit nicer. Yeah, that doesn't need to be like that at all. Okay, let's go like this. Neaten it up a little bit. So if you hadn't noticed, this is going to be a long episode. Just because it's number 50, really. Celebrate 50 parts. Oopsie daisies. Oopsie daisies. I think we actually did a little bit more than 50 because... Oh, that's not actually connected. That's a problem. Again, that didn't work. All right. Let's try that again. I want to connect it there, but it's not going to let me, is it? Are all the others connected? I don't think I ever checked. Yeah, they're all fine. Why is that one not working? Really? And then that won't connect. Oh, that's annoying. I'm going to have to do it there, aren't I? Yep. Well, that works fine. Not as pretty. I mean, it was never pretty, but that'll do. Yeah, no, I think we've done a little bit more than 50 just because of... there was a few, like, 0.5 parts, I think. And maybe, I don't know if I counted some of the live streams as well. I'm not sure. But either way, the number on this episode is 50, so we're counting it as part 50. That's all good. Also, there was a part 0, but that wasn't even in Knob City, so... Anyway, the idea is this is going to run straight through. And we're going to have tons of... branches coming off of it, and then it will just turn around at the end and go straight back. Hang on. It's not quite how I wanted to do it, but anyway, yeah, turn around at the end, go straight back down. So I'm hoping that this will just be... I mean, there's always lots of hope. I've also done this completely the wrong way around. I know, I just realized that. That's okay. I should have turned it the other way. So this needs to, every single section of this road needs to flip around. See, now the problem is, because I'm doing Afro City in left-hand drive and this in right-hand drive, I'm just going to get so confused. All right, let's just do this all in one go so I don't leave any bits out. There we go. So that should all be good. Beautiful. All right. Now let's connect this up. So this is going to get, obviously we'll bring that back a little bit. It's a little too close. It'll go. So this is the connection back on like that. And that will come straight onto there. Oh, it's beautiful. And of course we need to do the crossover bit. So let's do that now. It's going to go up. Oh, this is still floating. Oops. From before. I should probably turn that off. Over. Leave enough room for our other connection to come in. And of course that's not going to work. So let's move back a little bit. Go around. There we go. I don't know if we'll ever upgrade this to an actual highway. If we do, we're probably going to have to rebuild it all anyway. I don't think we'll be able to upgrade most of this. So that's going to come down to there, I guess. Yeah, no, that'll be fine. Okay, so that's going to feed this area. Let's also go turn it... I might as well pause because we don't really need the game running because there's a lot of demand for industrial, so we'll get it going. So it's all that grass area there. It's a beautiful shape. Let's just clean it up a little bit. There is a little bit of space there, though. Okay, so that's going to be farming. There we go. Right, now let's figure out how this is going to work. So I want a train station here, that's for sure. Maybe we'll do it, should we do it right at the end? Is that a good idea? The thing is, actually, something I've just realized is if we're going to just have all the farms coming off of it, so these guys will be coming off of it, we probably want the train station down the front because then these guys going down that way, we won't be able to get back. Because the idea is it will just be a constant loop in and out. So that, like, these guys won't be able to go back in unless they go out of it and come back. So if we do the train station down the front that they can both get to, that might be a good idea. Maybe we should even do a harbor. No, we won't do another harbor. Let's just do a train station down here somewhere. So let's go off the exit because everybody will be able to get to the exit area. So that will be here. Like that. So we will actually need to bridge the train station or the train line. Or maybe we'll just go underneath, I don't know. Actually, you know what we'll do? We're going to try... hang on, let me just build a road back here. We're going to try the method where you sort of just point the roads directly into it. Because I was watching... I've seen this on the subreddit before. And I was watching Conflict Nerd, his series, and he tried it out in his. Because we're also talking about it on Skype. Because what you do, you just point the road directly into it. Because, I mean, the main problem that you'll notice with any of our train stations is the traffic occurs when they're slowing down to turn in and turn out. So, if you can prevent that turn, it may be a lot quicker to get in. So, if we can go... Because they're... Like... That even. And then... So, the problem is trying to get the exit. You either just sort of come... Oh, come directly off of it. Can we just go like, no, I don't want to curve it. No, I don't want to curve. This is the problem with highway roads. Maybe if we do it out of a regular road and then upgrade it into a highway road, that might work. Because that will let us do it, I think. So if we go there and then out, hopefully that's close enough. I don't know. Then if we upgrade it, yeah, see, if you upgrade it, it works. I think, no, the entrance is actually about there. That's a little bit off. Let's try that again. If we can go... Maybe an even sharper angle than that. Sort of like that and then straight out. That might work. Let's try that. That's not ideal though. Those roads are a little bit too long. Can I bisect that and make it a little bit shorter? Of course I can't. Of course I can't make that any shorter. The exit isn't a problem. I'm not worried about that. Because otherwise we're going to have them slowing down to turn there anyways. The idea is to try and get the smoothest corners you can. And I don't know if we've achieved that. I mean, we'll only know if this works. It looks weird. Yeah, I'll give you that. But we'll only know if that works when people start using it. So let's go with that for now. Is that even... Yeah, it's cargo. I often make the mistake where I do the wrong one. Should we just go under? I do... I always prefer going under. You guys know that. So maybe we'll go under. Let's go... I don't know. Going under always just looks so much neater. Anita Bong hit. Man, I really wish there was somewhere you could just stream every episode of The Simpsons. That'd be great. Isn't it like Hulu or something that has it? But of course, we can't get Hulu in Australia, so... And also, Hulu sucks. Hulu, from what I've heard anyways, it sucks. I just want to be able to watch. Like, why is it on Netflix? Like, Family Guy's on Netflix. Why can't I put bloody Simpsons on Netflix? Simpsons is great. I mean, I have the DVDs. I think I've mentioned this before, but they're not digital. I'd have to rip them all to be a digital. All right, that's going to go across there. And then we'll smooth this out a little bit because that's a little bit ugly, which is fair enough. There we go. Good as new. Hopefully this will let me bridge it without it looking dodgy as hell. No, it will not. That's why you don't. If we can go... I guess if we just do this and then come back down. Oh. Well, how about I build towards where the road is? How about I actually build it, you know, in the right direction? Then it might be a good idea. So if we go up and across just a little bit, it might look okay if we do it like this. I can't really tell angle. There we go. No, that's all right. That's all right. That's just a little bit of a hump, a little bit of a humpty hump. That's all good. So then that will go up to there, across a little bit, and then back down. Yeah, no, that's fine. Okay, so that's going to be our train station. Of course, we need to get water and power and all that kind of stuff out here. So I guess if we go boop, like that, and then this will go, because we're going to need water in this area anyways. So that will go all the way up. As for power, now that's self-contained power, so we're going to have to get it from somewhere else. Maybe we go... No, because we're going to be redeveloping that area. Let's get the power from over here. Can we go... Okay, let's go... If I go from there, can I go under? I can go under there, but I really just need to go over that way. Maybe if we go up across the highway there... Ooh. Oh my god, there we go. And then... I'm just going to have to come across... to... See, that's a good idea. If we go in between, like in the middle of this highway section, that'll actually be handy because that will cover the whole area quite well. Oh my god, if it would stop, why would power lines snap to road? In what universe do power lines need to snap to the roads? Oh, God's sake. There is one spot where it worked. There it is. Okay. It's like, why would it do that? Okay, then that will go there. Right, so that's got power and water. Yeah, okay, stop complaining. We'll wait till it stops complaining. Actually, what I should do as well, do the usual, where we do the old turnaround, so the trains don't have to reverse out, because that tends to slow them down. So if they're going to be on the right-hand side, that's going to work, isn't it? I think so. I think that'll work fine, right? Could be on the right-hand track, and I'll go... Oh, no, that's going the wrong way, isn't it? Oh, I don't know. Let me see. So this one, they have to join from the left, or from the right, okay. And this is joining from the left, so that is definitely looping the wrong way. So that's not really useful. We need to go that way. Damn it. Alright, forget it. We'll sort that out later. Okay, so let's get the farming area. So the idea here is we have a bunch of roads that branch off. I guess we'll just use dirt roads, because we're not going to... The idea is we're not going to do too much on one road. Now, this idea I've had in the past, and it usually doesn't work very well. But let's see what happens. I don't want to do straight roads. Straight roads are so boring, especially for a farm area. Let's mix it up a little bit. I mean, it doesn't have to be super curvy, but I don't want it too, like, boring. So then I'm going to go this way a little bit. Maybe then we'll have the next one here. Then we're going to go this way. That'll cross over a little bit. I mean, I want to cross streams, though. I guess this should go in there. That should fill out that area. There you go. So if we... Let's just start off with a little bit. Like this section here that we're doing. And let's see how we go. So this is all going to be industrial. We can just do that. Fantastic. Now if they're smart enough and they build there, hopefully... if someone builds there, ideally that'd be great. Okay. Yeah, now we're going to need some services here. That's a good point. Actually, that's going to be a problem trying to cover the whole area with services, isn't it? Because it's all one way. Well, that covers that whole area. Oh, is this? Oh, because that's the exit. Oh, that's the entrance road. Oh, you idiot. Oh, I was doing left-hand drive again. All right, how many people did I annoy doing that? This needs to be on the other side of the road. This is on the wrong side of the road. Ah, god damn it. That's my bad. Yeah, sorry about that, guys. You probably got really angry. Hey, at least I noticed, though. That's always a benefit. oh, gosh. That would also solve our train loop problem. That should have tipped me off about that problem. Okay, this is going to go on this side, which actually solves a lot, makes it a lot easier for us, because that means we don't have to go under the road. We don't have to bridge that. We don't need the power line there. Wow, this makes it a lot easier. Oh, the comments must have been so angry just then. Put your hand up. All right, guys, put your hand up right now if you wrote one of the comments saying, you put the train line on the entrance road. I know you did. I know you did. Just as a little heads up, yes, you can delete your own comments. You can also edit your comments, so you can hide the evidence if you made that mistake. Or you can leave it there, but it's up to you. Okay, so obviously we're not going to have a dirt road going to that. We're going to try and do the same setup as we had just before. Let me just pause it, because we actually do have people building out here now, so we need to make sure we get all this ready. All right, so this is going to come in like this, and I was also building it the wrong way. I was building it that way. It should be coming in this way, because it's right-hand drive. So it's going to go, hang on, let's get rid of snapping, because we want it as close as we possibly can to the right spot. There, and then, actually, I want to build these roads shorter this time, because that was actually a problem I also did. So this one is going to go straight in there, straight out there. Now, that should work. How well? We don't know. So this is going to come... No, that doesn't need to go that far. It doesn't need to be far. Hopefully... Oh, I guess because it's only single lane, though. Maybe we should... No, I guess the idea here is it's going to be quick. Hopefully. No, I need a smoother... Hang on, let's just do this backwards. Let's do it. Snapping, please. Oh, it's not going to let me do it? Alrighty. Well, let me upgrade it first. Okay, maybe... Hopefully it will let me do it now. Yeah, there we go. Cool. Alright, so that's going to come down this way to about there, and then go into there. Obviously, flip that around. So that should be a nice, quick path on with minimal slow downage. And that'll come off like that. A little. I would like to make that a little bit... I would like to make that as symmetrical as possible, just so it doesn't look as weird. I mean, it's always going to look weird, let's be perfectly honest, but less weird. Because that's coming at a different angle. It's never going to be quite the same, is it? Hang on. Stop it. Oh, because I'm using the actual curve tool. No, I want freeform tool. No wonder. Okay, you go there. A little bit further down. Then we kind of had a little kick up for some reason. A little one. And then in about there. Ah, that's close enough. That's pretty good. Does that connect to... Oh, so close. So close to actually connecting. All right. Let's bring this back a little bit. Now this is going to go through there to there. The water now also does not connect, but that's fine. We'll just go straight out. While we're here, let's get all this. There you go. Okay, train line, which should also be a lot easier to do now because it'll make more sense. Okay, now the actual curve tool might be useful here if we go out to there. That's beautiful. That's actually really good. Okay, now this should actually work as well when we do our little train loop. Because it'll join from the correct side of the track. There you go. Right, that makes sense now. I guess I wouldn't mind doing a turnaround down here somewhere for people that want to go back again. Like coming from the train station they're trying to deliver. I guess that shouldn't be too big of a problem. Okay, so they've all got that now. I fix that now. In the end, it was the fire station that tipped me off. That I did the wrong way around. So there you go. So I guess ideally we want our services down the end of the road, right? Because then they can go to both areas. Or actually, no, we'd want them down here. No, we're definitely going to need more than like two services. Well, let's do one. Let's just get a road at the tip. Come straight out the tip. No, we can't do that. It's not going to let me. Let's go there then. This is where we're going to chuck. Hopefully... not a police station. I don't want a police station. It'll be fine. A large fire department. Now, that it covers all the way down there. So that'll cover everything on this side. So let's go with that. I guess we could probably go with police as well. Why not? I guess really... Okay. I didn't want to do this, but I think we're going to have some crossovers just because it will just make sense and it'll help us out. There we go. Because then that means these guys can also cover that side quite well. Alright, so that's actually pretty much killed our industrial demand right now, which is kind of annoying because I want to see this start working. I want to make sure it does work. And we don't currently don't have any traffic out here. Oh, here comes one dude. Do you reckon we should, maybe we should have a crossover there so people that are just coming in from the highway can use it, I guess. I mean, if this creates too much problem, it really shouldn't though, but if that creates too much problems, we can get rid of the little crossovers. Okay. Should we do one there? Nah, screw it. They can go all the way around. So is anyone going to use this? I want to see if people use this, really. I don't know, but that should be good. I always try out these new designs and I'm like, hey, this might work. Let's see how it goes. How's this area going? This is no longer gridlocked. I mean, it's still slow. This was always slow because these guys have to merge and then turn right and all that. Where are they all going, actually, is my question. So a lot of them are just trying to go straight on. Yeah, see, maybe we'd be better off connecting them instead of merging there. Maybe if we just merge straight up there, because they have to then merge there and then go through another intersection. If we can cut that down to just one intersection, that'd probably be better. Obviously, we're going to destroy some buildings through here, but I think it'll be better in the long run if we just go straight to there. Because that means, because they already have to slow down and merge there, but if we can just get them going straight through, that'll probably be better for everybody. Can that guy go away? Because that building is too small. Let's get a proper sized building there. There you go. I think that'll work better. I mean, if those guys could turn quicker, that'd also be helpful. So then when it's these guys' turn, they should go whoop, go straight out, straight across. I don't think we had traffic lights there before. I think I turned them off initially, but it might work. Why do they get to go again? When do these guys turn? They've been waiting for ages. I hate that about traffic lights in real life when you're sitting there waiting for so long. And you're like, oh, why do they get such a long turn? Is it your turn yet? Hey, there we go. So if we can get everybody through, which I don't think we're going to, that'd be ideal. Oh, maybe. Oh, no, we do. I think that's much better. We'll keep an eye on that. We'll come back to that. But I think that's better than what it was. Okay, how about we have a look? See if there's any real problem areas. Yep, no, there we go. So what is the cause of this? It's coming down this way. It's all these intersections along here because... Yep, okay. Yeah, so this is, when you turn off traffic despawning, that's when you see all your problems. Which is actually really handy to have that, but... It's... So they're coming through here. It's just all the intersections down this road. Because there's no traffic really in between them. It's just because they're stopping at the lights. Loads of them, I think they're just trying to go straight through. Like, if I have a click on that road... Yeah. A lot of them are just going straight on through. Which, I guess, ideally, I don't really want them to do. So if I click on this road, how many people from this area are using that? I would rather them use this highway and go around and not go through the district. So what happens if we just get rid of that? Don't let them go through there anymore. Like, if they can no longer go that way, that means they're going to have to go around. Which may cause more problems, but we'll see. I mentioned this in the live stream for Afro City. I wish there was a policy that said no through traffic. So then people within the district already would be able to use that road, but then, like, so through traffic wouldn't be able to come off this highway and cut through. I wish there was a policy that would let you do that. I don't even know how you do that in real life, to be perfectly honest, because people would probably still do it, but in the game, obviously, you could do it. Now, we're going to have to wait for... Okay, now what we're going to do... Screw it, because that's going to take a while to clear. Let's just clear traffic. That should divert... because it was obviously a quicker route for people to cut through. I mean, I don't know how that ended up being quicker, because especially with the backup, you'd think going around would actually end up being quicker. Because everyone's just trying to get through over there, so... I wonder if they will now... No, there's no other entrances onto that one, is there? You'd have to go all through the district. Like, you'd have to go up through that way. It'd probably be quicker to go on that. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. How are these guys going? Not enough workers. Yeah, well, that's a problem. Is this working, though? There are trains coming here, so that's good to know. Is anyone leaving, though? Not a single truck left. So I don't know if that's actually usable. We did have a train. Okay, there's another train coming. What has this got? If we have a look at it. Zero load. All right, so it's going to unload nothing. See, I don't know if this is actually working or not. I think I might wait a little bit longer on that. Okay, so I think we should build another residential area and not within the city. I think we need to build hopefully closer to this. Why don't we No, I don't want to tackle that just yet. That's going to be annoying as hell. Why don't we go for residential? I don't want to go too close to, to all the sewage dumping that we have. How are we going with that, actually? We're going to need more sewage treatment as well. This is a big city. This is a very big city. Well, why don't we go... We could even do residential, like, out here somewhere. Because, I mean, we got this whole half of the map, basically. Essentially, we've only used, like, that side of the map. We've got all of this over here, all this land. Where do I want them to live? Hashtag scum at conflict net. Beautiful. I think... I guess... No, I do want them to be around here. I think that would be good. But we'll make sure not to go... Let's just lay out the roads. Because we've got, like, basically infinite money at this point. So, let's just lay out the roads. Let's go for... do we even want a... Like, a highway? We don't need a highway coming into here. It's going to be, like, a little town, essentially. So, let's just go for a little road. Get away. Let's go here to there. We might do a proper highway entrance later on, but for now we'll just go a little road. Comes down into the town. This is going to be our main town road, like that. And then we're going to go no trees, because I don't think every road would have trees. I don't go along the water. I'm going to go not too close to those, because that will be stinky as hell. Go up that way. There's going to be like a fairly... It's not a small town, don't get me wrong, but it's not going to be huge. So we've got the train line there. So I don't want to go any further than that. So we're going to go... I don't want to go too close to it either. Basically, I want it to be a quiet little hamlet. So it'd be a nice little area to live. Not too dense. I don't want it too dense, but I don't want it too... Not dense. If that makes sense. I'll run along there. I can join onto that bit. I don't know why the road tool is glitching out so much, but it is. So yeah, let's go through here. Oh yeah, there you go. So it's sort of semi-grid, but not too strict with what we're doing. Let's be careful not to make a penis-shaped town. So let's go like that. I was gonna do a road there and join it up, and I was like, well, let's not go for that. This will keep going up this way a little bit. I think we'll go town border. Maybe that road, that intersection there. So we'll go. We won't go any further up in that area. We'll make sure to do plenty of parks and get all the services in as well. There we go. Like that. That's looking pretty good. Yeah, so I obviously don't need to build the entire town right now, but we are, so why not? I guess, why not? It's going to come through here. That's a lot of space. Maybe through there a little bit. And then what we'll do is we'll connect that road up, get a road through there. Maybe we'll leave that open. All right, so that's going to be a little town. That's all right. Not too shabby. Let's get in our district attorney. No, just the district. There we go. Don't want the train line in it. There we go. Wood Square. Nah, it shouldn't be called Wood Square because it's not really. It's like supposed to be a whole town name. Woodlington. There you go. That's what it's called. Beautiful. That's a really nice town. What I would like to do, though, is probably get some more trees between them and the sewage treatment, because I feel like it's a little too close for comfort. This seems to be like a pine forest kind of place, so let's go for... Get some large pines. I wish it wasn't that dense. That's a little too dense for me. But maybe we just go through with the bulldozer a little bit, thin it out. There you go, but now there's still a few trees between them. So you can see them peeking through the trees, but this is not right on your doorstep. Okay, so we got a little Woodlington. That's quite nice. How are we going up here? Is anyone using this? I don't think they are. Like, I don't think it's getting any use. There is a train coming. Anything in it? There is 20% cargo, so let's see if it empties out here. Because then we'll see if they can exit it. Because it might just be because of the fact there's no workers there and there's, like, no deliveries. So, I don't know. We'll see. Okay, he's coming out. Okay, so they can come out onto the road. Can they go in? Oh, well, there's a truck coming in. Oh, maybe it does work. Oh, it has to turn a little bit like that, but it seems to work. Oh, so, I mean, well, obviously it does work. It completely works. But they kind of have to do a weird maneuver to, like, swoop in, which is not ideal, but, like, watch this. Don't know why he has to do that when he could just go straight in, but whatever. It seems to work. We'll see how that holds up over time. Okay, let's go back over here. Let's get all the services that we're going to need. So we're going to need a, probably not a full hospital. Nah, a little clinic is more than enough to cover the entire town. We'll get a crematorium. Maybe we'll do like a little death road. Let's go death road out here. And this is going to be crematorium. And they'll even have a cemetery. Oh yeah, we should probably get pipes in here. Let's go like that. And cover that section of the town. Cover Death Road. It's kind of like Death Row, but Death Road. Down there. And that should cover everyone. Hopefully that guy's okay. Otherwise that's going to annoy me. Okay, power. Probably a good point. Well, if we drag it through the middle here, we won't affect zoning too much anyways. Yeah, we'll obviously we'll remove the power lines as we get to that point. So we'll just take it up here, connect to that one. And then this can just go around the town. Join over there. Okay, so that should be all fine now. Let's go for a... So we need a police department as well. That's the coverage, like, that's a large one. I don't think the green coverage really means anything. I don't even know what it means. It says efficiency, but it still will easily cover the entire area. So let's go opposite on the other side of the road. Well, we don't need schools. We've already got healthcare. So I think that's pretty much all we need, except for parks. So let's get some little parks in here. There's smallpox. That's going to destroy the power line in an inconvenient way. If I put it there, that should still carry the power across both sides. So that should work. Maybe a little basketball court. How about that? No, they don't want it. Have a little churchy thing. I don't know. It just looks kind of cool. Do they want a soccer field? It is pretty big. It's okay. We can do it down by the water, maybe. That's a nice little spot for it. Oh, well, no, that looks really bad because it's glitching the terrain a little bit. How about over here? Nope. Oh, there we go. Nope, that's glitching it even worse. how about further over this way? It's glitching it a little bit, so that's okay then. A little bit of glitchy, but that's all good. Okay, so the main road. Yeah, definitely this is where all the commercial's going to live. So all the way up the main road. That's going to be like our town line, that road. So we won't do anything up there. Then we're going to go... Pretty much everything else is going to be residential. So I'm just going to pause. Going to do the whole area. Then I'm going to dezone the parts I don't want. So like I don't want them living on Death Road. I don't want them living there. And I don't want them living outside of the town. And the rest should be fine. Live wherever you want, my minions. What I should do though is get some policies up in this joint. So, high-rise ban for sure. I mean, we're not going to get any high-rise. We did all low density. Tax relief is what I want for low density, and also tax relief for low density commercial, because it's a small town. You know, I don't need anything. No smoking in town though. We'll have recycling, better parks. We're going to go for free public transport. Might get a little bus service or something. I don't know. And that's pretty much all we want to do there. There's a few policies, but it's all pretty good. Let's go for a bus line. Let's go from down in the park, or the soccer field. I'm going to go through here. I don't know. This bus line doesn't really mean anything. I don't know if anyone's going to use it. Should we? I guess we'll take it up to... Oh, we can't stop on the main road anywhere. So, no, we won't go up there. I'm going to go around here. Oh, there we go. There you go, a little bus line to get around town. How about that? I mean, half the town misses out, like all those guys. But, I mean, I will build a bus line up there if, like, a lot of people are working there. But right now, we don't have a very big area up there, so we won't worry about that too much. Has everyone got power? Why would, of everywhere you could build, you decide to build right there in the smallest possible house? Why? Out of every, there's so many big plots of land, and that's where you wanted to build. In that little area. Alrighty. Well, this guy has the right idea. He took up his river view. Look at that. Got a nice view of the city. You can see the statue over there. It's all good. Now, Woodlington is going to be very nice. Got a little cemetery and everything. Okay, how is... speaking of the cemetery, how is the garbage dump going? That sounds awful. The way that segue sounded absolutely horrible. Speaking of cemeteries, how is a garbage dump? That's implying something I didn't want to. Everything else seems to be pretty good. Let's actually check out that traffic situation through here. Yeah, see, that's not good. Now they are all there. So is it... Wait, which way are people going? They're going this way. So why is this... Is it people coming through? Oh no, so these guys are trying to exit. Oh, I see. I see what the problem is. Now, okay, so... The main problem here... And I think what is causing everything else to back up is that we have an exit right after an entrance. So then these guys are backing up because they're trying to get out. They're trying to get in, but they can't get in because they're trying to get out. So we're just going to like a loop backup, which is not ideal. So I think we get rid of that. We can't have that there because there's an entrance right here. So it's not too far away. But if we can get those guys to go there, that will start moving. They'll be able to enter the highway without this section backing up onto itself. These guys are just backing up because of all that. Now, do we have any other really awful backup areas? Because that, I think that was the problem there. That's moving slowly, but that's fine. That is moving slowly, but it's fine. It's moving, so it's okay. I mean, I've had many suggestions that we should just connect this highway here up around to the roundabout intersection, which we could do, but not too worried about that just yet. So I'm going to look for any major issues that we have, such as, you know, that one over there. This area's always been a little bit of an issue, but no, it's moving though, so that's fine. That's all good. As long as it's not, like, completely gridlocked like this entire district is, then it's not so bad. I mean, they've stopped moving again. I don't know why. Why are you guys going? Oh, is it? It's still a cyclical loop. It's just bigger now. I think I just need to clear the traffic. Oh god. Yeah, see, it's causing issues all over there. Okay, clear traffic, go away. Alright, let's see how that goes. It's just we've got so much industrial here. We've got so much industrial that it's creating major issues. Plastic bag. We don't even have any... don't even have industrial space planning or anything like that on it. Does this have anything? No, it doesn't. Okay, well, let's see how that goes. Let's keep an eye on that. How's little Woodlington going? Yeah, it looks beautiful. It's such a nice little... Look at this little town. It's so nice. Oh, look, you get a view of the of Silicon Hilly as well. How about that? That's really good. Okay, that's good. That's all working. I mean, they have to do a really... They have to go, like, out and around. So I guess we could probably try and fine-tune this a little bit. Because if we watch... I want someone to come in, but I don't think they're going to. So we need more industrial as well, so we might get some more, let's work on that now, let's actually unpause. So we go a little entrance here. Nope, no. Oh no, that's right. Because this is all beautiful, fertile ground. Prime for farms. This can actually go out way further, like we have all this room up here. Might as well connect that, why not? Can this go through the middle? Just, makes it a little bit smaller, but that's okay. I think I might as well actually just connect this around to this area too. I'll go down. And around. Now this could create major issues, but we'll figure that out later. So this is going to go through here. And we can have one up that way. And for some reason curve like that and cover that area. That can join to there for some reason. That can go there. Okay. It might not make sense in most people's minds. It doesn't make sense in my mind either, but let's see how we go. You know, that's what we do here. We just test something out, and if it works, it works. If it does not, it does not. There you go. Loads more industrial. Okay, so let's jump back over here. So far, so good. No major backups, but then it hasn't really had enough time to get going. That's why you have to keep checking on it to see where it's at. To make sure it's working or not. All the trains seem pretty happy with it, so that's all good. This area needs... We need to redo that. They're building in there, slowly but surely. They seem to have to slow down quite a bit around this area. Let's have a look. This guy's going to come up and put some of the brakes. It's all good. As long as it doesn't back up, that's fine. Low amounts of workers there. Okay, so what we need to do, they need more commercial. Is there any areas that are just like devoid of commercial? Yeah, this area for sure. I think we need some more here. I don't want to go up there. Okay, so let's go along the waterfront a little bit then. I'm actually going to dezone some of this commercial along here. There you go. Maybe a little bit there too. That should make him a little bit happier. It's a nice little town. I can't wait to see it fill out. Let's see where everybody's going, shall we? A few of them go over to here. No, they're coming from there. Nobody's going to there. But most of them are commuting down the highway to this train station and they're going to this subway station. Okay. Or they're coming from it. No, they're coming from the subway station and going that way. Okay. Well, that's interesting. Well, where do most people work? So, okay, there's some people going this way. They go this way. Some are just... Okay, they're going to the harbour. All right. Well, why don't we just give them a road to go there? Because if there's enough people going there, I guess it makes sense. Might as well give them a little connection. Oh, Riverside Road. Now, we're going to have to... go over. I don't know if I'm really going to be able to go over it, am I? See, I need a... not ideal. Hang on. This might not have been a good idea. Oh my god. Did I also just cut... Yeah, cut off power to all you guys. Yeah, I thought I did. Let me just rebuild that. Let me just go from up here so it's safe, so I don't touch it. There you go. There we go. So I should reconnect everybody over there. All good. Yeah, no, this might have been a really bad idea. But how else do I get in there? Because I don't want to touch that highway road, but I think I might have to. Because, I mean, obviously it makes sense to just connect onto this road here. Like that. And then we have this road go over. So we just go up a little bit earlier, and then, yeah, that makes a lot more sense. A little bit sharp there, though. There you go. Anyway, so I don't know if anyone's actually going to use that, but I guess it kind of makes sense. So if people do want to go that way, what I should do, actually, before it happens, is go for a heavy traffic ban in case any trucks want to go that way for some reason. They can't go through the town, they'll have to go up to the highway. I mean, I don't know why they would, because it's definitely quicker just going up to the highway. Going up to that area, but in case they did for some reason, there we go. All right, so that's all good. There's still lots of commercial demand though. Oh dear. Not enough goods to sell. Yeah, no, that makes sense because there's no way they could deliver goods to the island. Unless we get a little bit industrial out here on the island. No, I think we're gonna have to. That's low density commercial, isn't it? Why is it so tall? How is that low density? I wanted small buildings. Is that even a district? Why is that not a district? They really should be. There we go. Holly Hills. No. It's going to be called Liberty Island. There you go. Right. Policies. High-rise ban, please. Does that get rid of those? Because I don't want them there. Now... I think we're just going to have to get rid of commercial on the island because I don't think it's going to be very beneficial. I think they're just going to keep complaining about not enough goods to sell because there's not going to be any goods on the island, I think, is the main problem. We can't deliver anything out here, so I think we'll just have to get rid of them. It's probably better just not to have those anyways and just have parks out here. Has anyone actually come out here? 3 tourists last week. Good. So it's, you know, popular tourist destination. I mean, they can get here. It's not a problem. Who else is in use? 1. 0. It's all good. Oh, I mean, we've got all the services we need. Just can't have any commercial. We even got garbage burning. How about that? It's all good. Okay. So, this is all working. As long as... Okay, so, I mean, they do have to make a weird turn to get in there, but as long as it doesn't create, like, issues with exiting traffic and all that, then I guess it's fine. But we can't really tell until there's loads of traffic. I really need to see one going in and one coming out at the same time. There we go. See, look at this. Oh, it does slow them down. Like, okay, what is that? Why did he go right in front of him? It does slow them down, and it does stop them, but, I mean, I don't think it's a huge issue right now. Yeah, a lot of them are going back again, aren't they? Because they're delivering. Oh, not at all. Not all of them. Some of them are. I just don't... Why are you doing that? What if we separate the roads? Is that possible? Let's see. Like, if we go there... No. Don't. I think I might have just dug myself a hole here. What if I build with this road? No, just don't join to that. And then, can I just build a... No, don't. Okay, no, I think what we have to do, if we go there to... What about that? I mean, okay, first of all, the roads are completely the wrong way around, so let me fix that. Can they even get to that? Here comes the truck. Let's see what happens. They still do a weird swoop out, but I don't think it's as bad. But I don't know. We really need to see exiting traffic as well. That might be a little bit better. I don't know. I thought, is that train coming in? It is. Okay, so this has got 33% cargo. So let's see what happens when they exit. If it still exits smoothly, then maybe that will be better. Or maybe it'll be worse. Let's find out after the break. No, let's not find out after the break. So they're going to come out. See, they have no problems coming out. I need someone to come in, like, right now before the trucks stop. And the trucks have stopped. And they've stopped. The second one gets there. Oh, here we go. They did cross over each other, but they didn't seem to slow each other down. Oh, that one kind of did. No, I don't know. Hang on, here we go. Are you coming in? No. Come trucks. I don't know. Let's keeping an eye on that. All right. Hey, this little Woodlington's starting to look quite nice, you know? Oh, they had a fire problem. You have a fire department right here, don't you? Somewhere around here. I'm sure of it. One of these buildings. None of them look like a fire department to me. Well, that's police. Oh, no, I did a medical clinic. I didn't do a fire department, did I? No, I didn't. Damn it. I'm sure the comments will let me know about that, too. Well, that's going to go right there, then. There you go. Yeah, the closest fire department, I guess, is all the way up here, isn't it? That one there. That's pretty big, though. Full fire station. All right, let's find out. Okay, first of all, let's go back over here. How's this area go? No, it's still created a giant issue. But it's not actually backed up. It's just everybody merging lanes is the problem now. Like, yeah, it's not actually stuck. It's just awful. It's just awful. That's the only problem, guys. No worries. Right. Looks like a lot of these guys are actually just going up and down, are they? Yeah, so we could even give them another just quicker way to get there. But this area is pretty bad. So let me see where all these guys are going, because it seems like some of them are just going straight that way. What if we even just did a little connect? No, not that. Oh, god damn it. God damn it. No, do that. Not upgrade. Give them a connection there. Because it seems like a lot of these people are just going around and straight off. Yeah, look, people are already using it. So if we give them a direct route to do that, maybe that would be a good idea. And then a lot of these people are also just going straight down there. So if we give them a direct route to do that. Because it's everybody coming along the highway and then cutting across like three lanes of traffic. That's the problem. It's not, at least it's not the problem of the traffic just getting stuck in a circle. Okay, so, I mean, that seems to be flowing better. Now, where's everybody else going? So, people coming on here. They really shouldn't be turning that way anymore, but it's alright. Yeah, see, a lot more people are using that now as well, which is good. How many people are going straight across? Because I guess we could even do... More roads are often not the answer. Often the answer is, your roads are awful. Fix them. But what if I just did that as well? Don't know why that considers itself a right turn. It should be really just go straight ahead, but... That's a pretty sharp turn for those guys. No, I was going to say not many people are using that. There are quite a few, but I think that's actually creating probably more problems. I think it's better if they just go around and join that way. Okay, so now we're just having slowdowns there, of course. Well, what if we go... Can I upgrade this? Because then that should hopefully chuck people going left in the left lane. And people that are going right should hopefully stick to the right lanes. I was hoping that they would speed up there a little bit, but that didn't seem to help at all. Okay, well, it's not so bad. It's not as bad as the initial problem. Well, I say that, and then we have a look at the rest of it. So what's causing all this, then? These guys trying to go that way. Where are you going? Are you trying to turn there? Are they just stuck in a circle? Well, a square. I think they are. Which is awful. That shouldn't happen. Like, that's something that just shouldn't happen. So one car gets to turn, and then... Yeah, these guys are just stuck in a circle because everyone in that lane is obviously trying to go this way. I don't know why that you aren't going. Maybe you're turning right as well, left as well. Then you guys are all trying to go this way because that's a one way. And then, oh god. That's, jeez. This whole area is just awful. What if we go, and then that's, what? Oh, now there? Okay. So now you guys stop because you can't get onto that road, which is now causing these guys just, oh god. So what am I supposed to do with this? Like, they're just stuck in a square. Like, the only thing I can do is just turn on traffic despawning. No, I mean, he was going into that area. I was going to say he despawned, but he didn't. Well, what if I go to two-way? Maybe that will help. I don't know. I don't know if it will. But let's find out. Go straight through there. That's already two-way, so that's fine. Let's go two-way on that. I'll leave that side. That side is not an issue. It's everything over here that's a problem. That's all two-way as well. See, I'm backing up all down here now as well. It's because nobody can move in this area. I just can't move. Oh, dear God. This never used to be this bad. Like, That is bad. Like, as far as bad goes, that's bad. Those guys are good. Little Woodlington is good. That's all fine. A little bit of abandonment up there. That's okay. That's okay. No worries. That's fine. The roads don't make sense in here. They all get stuck on themselves. Yeah, two-way certainly didn't help us out. We're just getting the same problem. Like, no matter what I do, it's just causing the same problem in this area. Like, these guys are trying to get in, but they can't get in because these guys are trying to go this way. These guys can't turn because these guys are backed up there. Oh, they're moving now. And these guys can't move because they're trying to get onto the highway, but they're stuck because they can't get onto here because those guys are stuck because they're trying to go that way. And then this has just created another little loop issue. Oh, dear. Oh dear. No, do we need that? No, because they can just come on over there, can't they? Let's get rid of that. See if that helps. Of course it won't help. It will just create the same problem somewhere else. For example, right here. What if we get rid of that one? Then we can create the problem down here instead. Oh dear. Oh dear. No, that's something. That is a problem. There we go, problem solved. Oh my gosh, that is just going to be a never-ending battle. This area is just going to be a never-ending battle. I made it too big. I've honestly learnt my lesson with industrial areas. Although the logging area seems fine. It's this plastic bag district, though, is awful. Smallville is doing quite well. I don't know. That's just not good. But everything else seems pretty fine. Let's get some more commercial. As long as we don't look at it, we'll forget about it. So that's all good. Out of sight, out of mind. Beautiful. So this is going to be... I'm just trying to figure out how I want to do this area. Because we've got all this space here. Now, I think I want to change this road because... connecting it there is going to be not very good. If we bring the road up here and connect it onto that highway, probably make more sense. I don't think we're going to connect it just yet, but so we'll like come up this way, connect on there somewhere. I guess we might as well just connect that bit. And then we can go for, so this is our little man-made avenue, which let me make sure I'm doing in right-hand drive for once. So this is going to go straight down. It kind of joins at a really inconvenient spot because we have that thing right there, but oh well. Then this will go straight down. Obviously got to reverse that. There we are. And this is probably going to be too close to the highway, so let's move back a little bit. Go back to about there. I was thinking of reworking this area a little bit, mainly because we should... I mean, we did try to connect this directly up, but then we had people driving straight through anyways, which wasn't ideal. I don't know, there's so many problems. There's so many problems in this world. They can't all be solved. So let's go... I don't know, let's just... I don't know, guys. It's just so difficult. Oh, dear. Let's go through here. Boop. Through there. Straight down there. Oh, that actually works perfectly. That connects up those two quite well. This can go in here. Sure. Why not? Let's just do that. Let's keep it simple. I say keep it simple, and this is probably going to be the most problematic area in the entire city, I bet. So you're going to get tons of commercial. Why is that not zoned? That should definitely be high density. That should also not be zoned. I guess that could be zoned as high density commercial right there, though. Is there any particular reason that this is not connected? Can I fit a little pathway there? Yeah, there you go. Now it's connected. So I can just walk straight through. All good. Nice. So, yeah, no, this area is fine, no problems. That should also probably will solve our commercial issue. Might as well just go straight down this road as well, actually. If we go like this, and we go like this. Do we have water out there, though? Nope. I guess we should probably just fill in this entire area, though. Because we're going to be building in here, so let's just go straight through. Let's go around here. There you go. Straight on up. I don't know, the pipes are in a weird configuration, but that's just the way it works in Knob City. So you come through. This city's going to get to a point, and I think it's getting pretty close to that point, where it just no longer works. where it just has issues constantly. Okay, so far, this area is holding up. We're getting a little bit of backup here. A little bit of backup there. A little bit of backup there. What is the cause of that? It's just traffic lights. Traffic lights. Oh, that's why. It's because whenever we clear the traffic, all the buses have to be regenerated. So it's spewing out 1.5 million buses. Okay, so that's probably something to keep in mind as well. All right, that's fair enough, I guess. Those guys are having a good time. Anyway, so that's taking care of that demand, which is good. Hopefully. Everything's working. Everything's flowing. Everything's working. Look at this little town. It's really nice. This is really nice. No, this is a really good town. I like this. I guess we could probably use some more parks out here, though, because I don't think they have a lot of parks in all the areas. Let's focus on something nice. Let's get them a little tennis court on Death Road. There you go. So that'll make those guys happy. These guys are pretty happy on that side. Could probably use another little thing up here. Maybe a baseball field as well. How about that? There you go. Have all the sporting equipment and a little skate park and get it over here. Maybe by the train line because it's a little bit more industrial. You know, have a skate park over there. That makes sense. Best town in Knob City. There you go. That's good. These guys are all abandoned because there's nowhere near enough workers for this place. Well, you know, you guys overexpanded. That's not my fault. I can't help that. You just built too much. Just because I zone it doesn't mean you have to build it. Hope you've learned your lesson. This area is still working well. So let's have a look. Yeah, no, that's already, yeah, this is going to have the exact same issue again. You know what? Let's solve the problem. Enable despawning. There we go. then the massive backups won't happen. I mean, the only reason I like to test it with despawn off is so you can actually see where problems are happening. Because if we get the whole citywide lack of goods issue again, that's going to be an issue. But I think we're pretty good. We definitely don't have that problem right now. How's this going? 7%. That's only gone down 6% this entire video. That's like an hour and 5 minutes has gone down 6%. Well, good. Good. That's all it needs. How's this dude doing? 0 out of 1,000 patients. 0 out of 63 ambulances in use. Patients treated last week? 0. Well, that seems to be working well. Fantastic. Okay. No, this is, yeah, this is good. Okay, let's get back over here. So, well, obviously we need to fill in most of this area here. So let's go ahead and get some roads going through here. Let's get some regular roads. And go straight through to there, I guess. And I can go into there. I don't know. Just building roads. Don't even care anymore. It's going to be a road. There we go. I wish it wouldn't, like, leave weird glitchy zoning like it has, but it has, so that's just what happens. Okay, that should be pretty good for that area, I think. Yeah, I already did all that, didn't I? I already filled it all in. I want the fill bucket. I guess we could do some residential in here. I guess I don't want solid commercial everywhere. I wouldn't mind doing some residential in that middle section. So we'll leave that bit open. And maybe in that little triangle as well, that'd be good. So I think this will be residential. And that will be residential as well. Let's get some parks as well, because I don't think we have much over here in this vicinity. We have, oh, that's 3 wide. I wish that was 2 wide, because then we could get the, that little park that's really big. Let's go for, no, I don't want to build that. So that, I don't want to build it in the residential areas, otherwise we're going to make them smaller. So let's go for small playground. Go there. And then we'll get a plaza with trees. Maybe over there, because that'll make those guys happy as well. Then we can go for a, let's go to like a giant park right over here. There you go. Oh, it's making everybody happy. I mean, it's got no power, and it's probably not functioning yet. The continuum transfunctioner is not functioning. I guess what we might do is, instead of having this overpass like that, is actually get rid of it. And I think we'll build our road going over it instead. So this is going to go up and over. So our avenue is actually going to continue all the way down here. 1, 2, 3. It's going to come back. I don't know what we're going to build down here. I've got no idea. It might even just be an industrial area as well. But we'll see how we go. Oh, is that not in the right spot? How is that not right? I thought it was supposed to be... Okay, no, that's only 2 wide, that's why. Whoops. I thought I went 3. 1, 2, 3. Oh, but that only makes it 2 wide, so you gotta go 4. Oh, okay. So we have to go 4 to make it 3. That makes sense, I guess, in some universe. There we go. Okay, so that'll go over like that. Then what we'll do is... Oh, that's not going to be, that's still not going to be very easy to connect, is it? That needs to connect to this road here. Well, if we can get this to go under there. Oh, that connected to it? I thought that was going under. That looks like it's going under, right? That is, so. Like this. And that goes under there, and then I have to go around. And then we can go from here. No, that way. Now that's probably just going to create a traffic nightmare there, but I like that a little bit better. Yeah, so this might just be industrial in this area, I think we might do that. Just extend this little area out a little bit. Now that doesn't mean that we're going to get a lot of traffic coming across this bridge. Now that might be a really bad idea. But we're going to roll with it. I guess this one can also come off of there. Actually, maybe we'll... No, I was going to say maybe we'll get rid of that so they can go down and around. But that's going to be even worse. Unless we just go... See, that doesn't make any sense. Why would I do that? Why would I make them go on the bridge? It just seems like a really bad idea. But how else would I do it? I don't know. I'm going to get rid of that road. I don't want that. Well, that can be fine for now. It'll be like that for now. That'll be good. So this area should no longer be backing up because all the traffic that is backing up will despawn. So that solves that problem. Good. Good, good. Trains? No, trains are flowing. It looked like they were backing up a little bit, but they're not. So that's fine. That's all good. This area is actually filled out very nicely. Plenty of traffic going up and down here. So a lot of people are trying to get across there, I guess, are they? Yeah, so that's not ideal because that means people just trying to go into the area are getting stuck. Which is not how I hoped it would work, but I guess we're getting a lot more traffic up here than I actually originally thought we would. A lot of abandonment. You know, I understand. They're abandoned because they didn't have enough workers. Yeah, well, it disappeared, so I can't confirm that. Do I want to... I mean, I could either do an overpass. Or I could do... I was thinking of making that a larger road. I don't want a larger road, though. Let's go an overpass. Let's go... So it's going to go from here. It's going to destroy the power line. But that's okay. Let me just pause while we do this, actually. Really good idea. There we go. Now the power line is going to have to raise up. Going to have to raise the roof to get the power line over. So let's go power lines and up and over and down. There you go. Beautiful. I don't know if that's actually going to help us or not. But that should be fine. How are you guys holding up down here? Let's have a look at Woodlington stats. 2,966 people. So it's not exactly a small town. It's pretty good. It's a pretty decent size. With a lot of adults, not that many teens, not that many children, not many young adults either, really. And only 18 seniors. Very young town, very hip and happening. Very hip and happening. So good, how are we going over here? You guys doing well? 126 people are already buried here. Wow, that was quick. I guess it's been a few years, a couple of years. Okay, no, that's good. So I'm kind of just waiting for more demand to crop up. We're getting a little bit of commercial, but we have tons of commercial zoning over here, so... And I can only imagine that's going to create traffic issues as well, coming from this industrial area here. But I think that highway there for the connection actually helped out quite a bit. So I want to, let's connect up this area because this should probably be connected. And I'm going to have to move that train line. I really should stop building train lines so close to highways when I know I'm going to need to do connections there. Let's actually just get rid of the whole train line and move it further back from the highway. Because it's just not... convenient. It's not convenient at all. There we go. That should be plenty of room, hopefully. There we go. Right, hopefully that's enough room to work with. So we're going to go from... probably not that far back. About there. Leave enough room for the exit. Bring it quite sharp and let's go about there. So, no, not the exit, the end. Entrance? Wait, how does this work again? Oh yeah, this one goes this way. Yeah, the entrance is what I needed to leave room for. So that can go to... No, that's not going to work. It's going to go up and to there and down. So a little lopsided, but it works. Can't argue with results. Switch traffic lights. There we go. So they can go both ways now, so that's good. So they can actually use that. So we should hopefully get more people using that route. Might even get some industrial traffic going this way instead, which would actually be good. Take a little bit of a load off of over there. That's for sure. This traffic here might even come that way as well. They also currently don't have an actual exit to get here. So we should probably give them one. I really don't like what I did with that. I really don't like what I did with this. This is a bad idea. I thought it would have been cool. It was not. I want to go under, but it's so, like, the levels. Look at the levels. So many levels. So if we were going to go under, we'd have to go really quite far down. We'd have to go, like, if we get rid of all of this, we'd have to be at this level, but lower. So we'd have to go from there. Yeah. So let's actually get that level, bring it down. And obviously, we'll make this a bit smaller as necessary, but for now, that will be the size. So, if we wanted to go under, oh wow, that have to go a long way down. So this is gonna, let's go ramp. So we're gonna go from there to there. So that actually works quite nicely. All good. So I'm gonna go, I don't know, I always just prefer under. This is why I can't wait till we get tunnels. I really cannot wait. It's gonna be so good. I'm gonna go over and join onto there, and then hopefully all this should actually just build quite nicely back across without too much issues, too many issues rather. That would make more sense. Two there and there. There you go. Well, it doesn't really like doing this, does it? But we can go to there and then across. There you go, that works. And then we can bring some of this land back up a little bit. So let's go get that, bring this up around. It doesn't need to be quite that far down. There you go. I don't know if that actually is neater or not, but it kind of looks cool, I guess. It's kind of cool, I guess. I guess we should definitely connect, like have an exit to this road here, because then people could actually get into the city that way as well. So we might do it. Should we do it off the same exit? I guess so. It makes sense, right? I might have to bring that back a little bit, though. Let me build it from this road. So I'll go backwards. Flippity floop it. And then actually do the same thing here. Backwards and flippity floop it. And have an exit to there. There you go. So I can actually enter the city that way. They will have to go around, but that should be fine. So, yeah, look, some people are already using it. This guy's happy with it. He can go up, go into the city. So that should be pretty good. So that means some of these guys, if they're trying to get into the city quickly, can go that way instead of, I guess, otherwise they would have to go this way and go around. So I guess that's probably a little bit quicker. Not ideal that they have to go down the bottom. So I might actually just make this road shorter. This might be the end of our little avenue here. It might make it a little bit more sense anyways. So I'm going to go, wait, how many is that? Doesn't it normally have a little counter to show how far I'm going on this mod? No, it doesn't. Okay, I thought it did. Well, I guess about there is right. There we go. Yeah, so we'll do that instead. Then we'll just have some other roads down here. So this, yeah, I think we'll expand this into another industrial area. Probably won't be connected to that one. Just be connected to these two roads. I guess there should be a way to get to the train station here. But actually, there should be, because we're going to end up with the same problem if I just connect it straight there. Like, people, instead of going onto the highway, they're going to go via the train. Oh, this is might be quite hard. Maybe we shouldn't do industrial down here. It should be something else. We could do houses. Waterfront houses between two industrial areas. I mean, the NPCs don't really care as long as they have a nice place to live. Let's just give them a nice buffer. Buffer, 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 buffer. Or buffer between the train station. Not as dense as I would like. How come sometimes it's like super dense and then... Maybe because the trees are smaller. Maybe when the trees are bigger, it makes it like denser. Hang on, let's clear this out. Let's clear it out. So if I use these trees... Oh, there you go. That's what you're after. Buffer, buffer, buffer. Buffer. Just block all that out. So it'll just be a small little area here. And then we have a little residential pocket. That'll be nice, right? Why wouldn't you want to live here? Let's just get them along the highway here too to, you know, block it out a little bit. Between that little area. It's a very heavily wooded area, so it'll be very, very nice. There you go. You can barely see it. How good is that? You can't see the train station. You can't see that industrial area. No, this will be good. Let's just put a few more trees there. You can see the oil industry over there, but that's fine. Oh, this will be good. This will be very good. There's no residential demand currently, and we're losing people, but, you know. This will be good. I promise. So if that's the end of our road, where should I have a little residential roads? Here, I guess. So we can go straight down along the water. So obviously they're not going to build on the water side. They'll have the road between them and the water. So they'll build on the inside. I don't like how the trees go orange when they're near water, but oh well, that's just the way it is. So this is going to go up this way. And that's going to go there. There you go, that'll be good. As long as it's not too polluted. I think it's better than doing another industrial area, because that'll probably generate way too much traffic, so I think this is probably the way to go. This can be a little district of its own. Umber district. No, it's going to be woodland pocket. Oh, pocket. No, just pocket. Regular pocket. Woodland pocket. There we go. Ah, that's good. What kind of services do we have here? Probably nothing. They don't even have a fire service. What if we put one here? Will it reach? No, what if we put one here? See, this reaches actually over there, so that might be a good idea. Yeah, that reaches that entire area. So if we just go fire department over there, that will cover woodland pocket quite nicely. Make all those guys happy. Police department, we could probably put on the other side. I guess I don't really want any services actually in it. Probably should be in that side. Actually, if I put it above that road, then I can get over there quite easily too. Yeah, so that should be fine. It's not too close, but it's not too far away, so that should be okay. And then what else do we need? Clinic. Where's our nearest one? Over there. Oh, a lot of... Yeah, we're getting a death wave through there right now. So that's all good. So that's all good. Yeah, we're getting a little bit of death wave, but that's fine. Do we want to go for a large hospital? I guess if we just chuck it in there as well, that will cover the entire area. Yeah, they'll cover those guys too. So that'll be all good. Where's our nearest crematorium? All the way over there. So why don't we put one here? Some kind of weird in the middle of the road. Actually, no, let's not do that. It's supposed to be an avenue. I don't want to put it in the middle of the road. Right next to the hospital. There you go. That will cover this whole area quite nicely. As for parks, I think we'll do parks over this side. It's not that close, but I think it should be good. Like, that should be okay. Because I'd rather this all be residential down here. I mean, I guess the only downside is they're going to have a lot of industrial traffic, you know, just coming through here, but that's fine. As for entrances to the highway, we should definitely have some. I think we should have one here for the end of this avenue. Is that going to be in the way? It most certainly is, except unless I do it like this. There we go. And as for an exit, we should definitely have one. That will branch off of there, and I guess go in like that. Okay, so there's an entrance and an exit. Oh god, we have a lot of traffic coming in. But that's okay, as long as that doesn't back up. So that's fine. But it's only from one side of the highway. If you're going the other way, you can't even get onto it. They can get off of it, but they can't get on. There's not really an easy way to connect the highway this way without going all the way around this industrial train station. Which is not ideal, unless we go in the middle. I don't know if there's actually enough room to do that. I don't think there is. They can enter and exit this side of the highway. They can exit from this side, but they can't enter going that way. Which is not ideal. I mean, the only way they would be able to is go on that way, go through the industrial district and go around. That would work, but not ideal. I mean, the only other way is... I don't know. You'd have to go all the way around that. But that's not ideal. I don't know. Maybe we just forget about it. just forget about it. What are you doing? Get out of the way. I wish trucks, when they pull into a place, they'd actually like pull into it and not just sit half on the road. It's really quite annoying. Okay, so we got more commercial demand. Why is there so much commercial demand? Like, this whole area did fill out, but there's like barely any residential that filled out. All right, we'll go all down there as well then. That whole area filled out too. So much commercial demand. Is that in Hemlock Heights? Because I'd rather it not be. Yeah, good. Because Hemlock Heights is the one that has all the business benefactors, which I don't really want them to have. Because that just creates more traffic. So this is actually going to be a separate district. Actually, up to that road there. I should probably neaten all these districts up at some point, but oh well. I guess that will be one there. I guess actually all of this area here will probably be this district. Like that. And then this can be a separate one. Probably this side of the road. So all down here. I don't know how big this is going to be, but for now it'll just be like this. There we go. So that's separate. Okay. That should be pretty good. it's beautiful. We got plenty of people using this road now, actually. I think that's pretty good because, yeah, it prevents everybody from using the same entrance, which is nice to see. Let's have a look at our traffic, especially over here. Well, it's not locking up because we've got traffic despawn. As long as we don't end up with issues such as not enough goods being able to get around the city, then that's good. Which I don't think we have any of that right now. I think everywhere is pretty happy. That guy doesn't have enough people, I think, visiting. That guy's complaining about something, but that's not goods. I think that's natural resources. But I think everywhere has enough goods to sell. Those guys are abandoned because they don't have enough people to work there. Well, you know, it's just, that's just life, isn't it? Not having enough people to work? Well, not really. Life is quite the opposite. And that nobody can find a job. And that sucks. Okay, so, well, let's start. Okay, I was going to say, let's start populating this area. Because we had residential demand, but it's gone. Because they probably built over here. They probably built there instead. Oh, look at it. I love all the people walking around here. It's absolutely a work of art. So, actually, where does that train line go again? Guys over here. Oh yeah, just dead ends there, doesn't it? Yeah, okay. Woodland. I really do like Woodland Pocket. It's a fun little place. Let's actually zone this. No, I don't want anyone living there. Actually, I want to make sure they don't zone on that avenue, but I want them to zone there, just so they don't build on that little one-way road. So that guy's going to be quite close to the train tracks, but that's fine. You know, if he chooses to live there, he chooses to live there. Not my choice. Not my fault. There you go. Start building! Yay! Oh, there's no demand. Well, you know. Okay, so down this road, I guess we should probably get trees in it. I really should just make a three-wide park that we could put in there. That we could just repeat over and over again. That would be really smart. Let's go do that. Save game. This is part 50. Let's play 50. You may notice I cleaned out the a million save files I had. Alright, let's go quit to main menu. A little bit unorthodox, but you know, this is a super long episode. It's number 50, that's fine. We'll do something a little bit different. So if we make 3x3 parks, because we can't do a long park because we needed to place it on the side of the road. If that makes sense. So if we get no content manager. Tools, asset editor, new asset. Let's make it in the tropical one because that looks the nicest. And yeah, we'll make 3x3. Really, all I want in the park is tree lines. I guess we could do a pathway going through it. I'm not sure if I want to. So we're going to make a park. So 3x3. So basically, the idea is we're going to have, if you look at it this way, we're going to have the avenue, one road there and one road on the top. So this is in between. And we want to evenly space all the trees out when we put this together. So I'm not sure what trees I used before, but I guess it doesn't really matter because we'll be changing it up. I want some tall trees. Do I want those ones? Are those too big? They might be too big. Those are quite nice. Okay, that's it. So we got those, we have those, and we have that little one, which I don't want. Okay, so let's go with, how about palm tree? No, that's way too big. I don't want that. Let's go for maybe this one. That's probably good, right? What is that super tall tree? The one we used near the airport one time. I don't know if they're actually in here, are they? No, I don't think they have them. Let's go with these ones. I think these will be good. So if we go, we're trying to evenly space them here. So we need to think about, I guess it has to go on every grid line. No, because then we'll skip. If we do one, I'm just trying to, hang on. How does this work? So we need to do a tree every, this will be about there and there. Oh, wow, that's really small. No, that's too big. That, okay, for God's sake. Don't change sizes. I want the same size tree. Yeah, there you go. Okay, so if we put one there, then I think that's, no, that's not going to be the same spacing though, is it? It's hard to imagine. I'm trying to imagine putting them side by side. So there's like 3/4 there, 3/4 there. So it's going to be 1.5 to the next tree. So next tree will be about there, which is actually a little bit further. So I need to move. Well, this is riveting content. So this is, maybe if we put them in the middle of those two. No, that doesn't make any sense, and they're even closer. So if we go, why am I doing 3x3? This is too confusing. Let's go 4x4. No, not that way, the other way. This makes it way too confusing. Okay. If we do it this way, then we can just go on that line there and that line there, and then it will be perfectly fine. Because that will repeat in the same distance every single time. Which I should have done the first time around. Okay, that's going to go there. That's going to go there. Then we can just place tons of these. Now, I wish those weren't all... Because we're going to be repeating this over and over, I want the trees to be probably the same size. Otherwise, it's going to look weird. Is that actually changing? I don't know. Hang on. No. God damn it. That's close enough. Yeah, no, that's fine. That one's a little bit shorter on the right there, but that's okay. Those are in the wrong spot. Can I move them? Oh, I can. That's easy. Okay, so you're going to go there. Now, do I want a pathway going through these? Because it could get quite repetitive if we have loads of pathways. But we could have one going through the middle. Or is that going to be too big? That's not a pathway. What am I doing? Because they take up a whole grid square. So that... I mean, I don't know if I want to do that. I think we need to make them longer if we wanted pathways going through. Like, if we go... Maybe... Can we make them 8 wide? We can. Because then we could do... So it'd go 8 wide. And then at the beginning and end of them, we could... Okay, well, that's dumb. We could do this. So then every 8, there'd be a crossing. Obviously, we need to redo the trees. Or add more trees, rather. So we go one there. And one would go there. And that should still repeat fine. They are the wrong size, though, so we will have to change those. That is definitely the wrong size. That's definitely the wrong size. That's definitely the wrong size. That's probably okay. Let's get rid of those three. That one's fine. This one's a little bit too small, I think. So if we go like that. Okay, so then this will be... That's a little bit off-center, that one. Or off where it's supposed to be. So then we'll repeat this down... That area there. I guess, do we want anything else in there? Do we want benches or anything? Not really. I mean, I don't really want people hanging out on it. And also, whenever you place an item, it makes it really, like... Look, it just gets rid of all the grass. It kind of looks dumb. I don't like that. No, I don't want benches. Go away. It's not supposed to be a park. It's supposed to be a way to walk through. And no power or anything like that. So let's go for electricity. Yeah, 0. Common construction cost 500. We'll probably make it... It wouldn't be that expensive. I don't know what these numbers mean. Obviously, the cost is that. I might lower maintenance cost because it's only trees and a pathway. Let's go 50. Fire tolerance. Well, there's nothing to burn. I mean, sure, the trees would burn, but... So, this fire tolerance is a higher number better or is a lower number better? I don't know. Because if it's tolerance, I feel like a higher number would be better. So, if you went like 600 fire tolerance. I don't know. Let's just leave it. Tourists... Well, I don't really want tourists, do I? There's no water. Entertainment accumulation. I don't know. I don't know what that means. Element radius 400. Entertainment radius. Element radius. What am I talking about? So is that 400? Is that talking about 400 squares? Or is that... I don't know. I don't know. I'm just going to leave it. I don't care. Train track. Oh. That's interesting. Didn't know you could do that. Station track. Oh. Wait, what the hell is the difference? Oh, is this so you can, like, make your own custom stations? I don't know. Anyways, let's just leave that. Let's leave that behind. No, that'll be fine. That's good enough for me. Let's go. I don't want any hangout markers or anything like that because they're not supposed to hang out. Like I said, this is just supposed to be a little walk-through park to add a little bit of decoration. Did that make a picture? I don't know. I have no idea. Save asset. Yeah, I did take 2 pictures. Oh, well, whatever. A new asset is going to be called... Avenue Park. Sure. Oh, did that just save? I wanted to name it. I don't think I actually named it because I was going to name that bit there. Avenue Park. Asset name. Park. It's a park for the avenue. Idiot. Save. Yes. Okay, good enough. No, don't load asset. Quit to main menu. And let's see how that goes. So that should hopefully, I mean, it probably won't exactly fit because we did 8 wide. It probably won't exactly fit all the way down, but it should be pretty good. Let's play 50. And let's see how we go. That should be quite nice. And it should hopefully be spectacular. I don't know why I said it like that, but it should be. Let's wait till it loads up. Wow, this city takes a while to load these days. little bit of lag there. Oh, there goes Chirpy. Little Chirper. There we go. Oh, whenever it used to load in, there used to be a roundabout there. It's gone now. Well, that created a lot of problems, so that had to go. Okay, back over to the avenue. So we should be able to just place these all the way through, or as many that can fit evenly. Right. Now we're going to find it. 3x3, 3x9, 2x4, small car park. Okay, no, maybe it's further. No, I don't know where the hell. Maybe it's at the end. Maybe it just adds it chronologically. What's that? Avenue Park, there it is. All right, so this should go one, two, and then obviously we'll continue it ourselves there. This should also make everyone really happy. What the hell? Oh, it's a subway station. Can I move that down a little bit, or is that? Nah, damn it. All right, well, we'll have one there. Why not? No, that looks good. That looks good. So if we can keep... Why does that not connect on that side? Because it... what? Oh, it's just glitching out and connecting there. That should not be like that. Well, that's good. Good to know that it's glitching. So this goes all the way down here. Like that. Oh my god, that actually fit perfectly. That actually fit perfectly in the whole area. Look at that. There you go. So they can now... Pedestrians can now walk side to side anyways. And that should make everyone ridiculously happy too, because they're parks. And it makes the road look pretty good, so I'm happy with that. There you go. Avenue Park. It's a park for the avenue, idiot. Beautiful. so I feel like they're probably going to make people extremely happy. It might be a little bit hacky, but I don't know what values I'm supposed to use, so whatever. Please don't get stuck in a circle there, because I will be mad. I guess it would have made more sense to do these roads the other way around, wouldn't it? So they can't get stuck in a circle. Because then, yeah, that makes more sense. I mean, that's technically a left-hand drive now, but they can't get stuck going in the circle like that, so... Whatever. But then they can't get to that road. If they wanted to go that way. No, that doesn't make any sense, does it? But then I don't want them... Because then those people can get stuck. I don't know. Maybe we need traffic lights. And on that one there. Just on the diagonals. Maybe that will help. Because if we do it on all four, that wouldn't be ideal, but... I don't know. Well, we'll keep an eye on that. I mean, that should never really be a big problem, because it will despawn if it's a problem, because we got traffic despawning. Okay, so I need more commercial. Why do they want so much commercial? Stop being such trolls. Like, how could you... Why? Like, why do you want more commercial? The city is like 90% commercial. Especially there in Dinky Square. Where do you want it? I wish there was like a little hotspot, like a hotspot map that said where they want commercial. Maybe there is. I've never looked. Leisure. Whatever. Districts. Oh, that's a nice little map. I didn't actually know that was a map you could look at. Look at that. That's good. See a city. It's nice. Yeah, all these districts over there are messy. These are all like nice and neat to the roads. And then that's just... These are all filthy. I might fix them up one day. It's all good. What else we got in here? Land value. High land value. Oh, look at that. Beautiful land value. Really good. Really good. No, they pretty much the entire city is incredibly high land value. Oh, actually, that was probably because when we put in that thing that made the land value high, isn't it? Yeah. No, that's good. Population. So we can see where everybody lives. Most of the people live right here in Midtown. Or around Midtown. Mostly adults, anyways, that live there. Transport. Yeah, whatever. Crime. Yeah, whatever. What else we got? Fire. Oh, wow. They didn't have good fire coverage in there. That's pretty bad. Everywhere else is very good, though. Except for that little area. Pollution. All good. Huh? Yeah, Woodland Pocket is okay. No pollution there. That's good to see. Traffic. A lot of people going that way and then going through this road. Using that as a little through road, I see. A lot of people coming through this way. Yeah, no. Okay, that is definitely a problem. So, hang on, where are they trying to go? Are these guys, what are they trying to do? So, yeah, some of them, I don't know, it's just... That is not a good intersection. I think what might be better, instead of having them all going there, if we go, so one of them will be a bit further down, so it'll be down here, for example. So they can go across there. That means they can still get to that road, and then they've got another crossing back over here, so they can go that way and come back across. So instead of centralizing all the traffic there, that might be a bit better. So what issues have we created? Yeah, we got like this being used as a through road now. Is that one way? Is that what the thing is? Yeah, that's one way. So maybe we should turn that into two way, because that's not really being used that much as a one way road. So if we turn that into two way tree line, hopefully some people will use that instead of going, because I think a lot of people are coming up this way and turning right. So that means they're trying to probably get through over that way. Still getting loads of people just like going in a circle here. This avenue is probably not the best idea I've ever had. But it's an idea I had, so I guess I got to deal with it. Alright, well. Well, shit, basically. Either way, that area is going to have a lot of traffic, because that's like all commercial. Like, commercial has a lot of traffic. That's not so bad. Like, I think this is probably our worst area now. The one I just did. Good. Oh, how's this going, by the way? 5%. It's almost done, guys. It's almost empty. The port is almost ready for redevelopment. Why is there so much demand for bloody commercial? I just don't get it. Let's do something out over here, because we've got all this space that we're not using, so. That park is actually in a really inconvenient place, because I want to put it a little bit further up so I can actually build a road there. Home Improvement Center. No, yeah, I want to build a road right here. Go that way a little bit, and then of course this will go this way as well. And then we can fill in the area with lots of commercial, hopefully. Let's go straight on through. 20 cells, go down this way. A little bit of a sharp turn, but that's okay. Let's go there. Go straight in there. I'm not going to join that up, I don't think. No, that's a dumb road. That's just a waste of space. We'll do parks in there. That'll be fine. Okay, so expanding this area. I haven't been here for a while. I've not done this area for quite some time. So all of this. I should probably check the services in this area, because that guy's dead. I don't know if we got death care nearby. So we'll look into that. There we go. I don't think I'll be doing any more custom avenues in the near future. Mainly because they create a little bit of an issue. I think because what is happening? So where does this road go? That goes up to there. I think people are probably using that as a through road, maybe, to get up there, are they? No, not really. There's not much traffic on that road. But they're definitely, I mean, that's not as bad now, actually, but that's definitely a very heavy trafficked area. That's just because there's loads of commercial, really. It's not so bad anymore, but it's not great. How's our little transport? This should be definitely going to be more and more busy, this transport hub area, because of everything around it now. Because that used to, remember back in the day when it was only built out to there and there was nothing out here? And I was like, look at this. It's absolutely something. Look at this road. See, it looks nice, I think, but the problem is it doesn't really function very well. It doesn't function very well as a road. Which is, I guess, somewhat of an oversight. But can I fit another one? I can. How about that? There you go. Yeah, it doesn't function very well as a road. Which is, some may consider a little bit of an oversight. I guess we should probably get some more subway stations in. Or at least reconfigure this a bit. Like, why? I don't know why I've built it like this. Do we really need more? Maybe not. Maybe that's probably fine. Because I can get off there. That's fine, I guess. There's probably quite a few people using it now, too. 330, yeah, people do use that, that's good. Zero, absolutely zero people use this one. One. So that might be a station we should, yeah, I think we should just get rid of that, because that's completely useless then. Because it's probably, it's quite close to the others. Like, it might even make more sense to put one out this way a little bit, have the subway go this way and then back in. So maybe we'll do that. So we're going to go subway station about there, maybe. No, it really needs to be facing toward where we're going. So if we do it there, then we're going to go, yeah, Am I paused? Yeah, I'm paused. Okay, let's get rid of this. Because that station had no one using it at all. Completely useless. Then we'll go from there. This way. And... actually, I wonder if we should even take one down to Woodland Pocket. Maybe we should even go down there. I don't know. Maybe that should be a different line, though. Because we can fit another one in there. Just means I'd have to move this line over. But we can definitely fit another line in. We might even do that. I don't know. Not just yet, though, I don't think. But in the future, maybe. So that's going to go on to there. Right. So we need to move that one over to there. And also that one over to there. Good. And then that can go away. Alright, because, I mean, nobody was using that, so I guess this might be a little bit more useful. It's kind of, because it's right by some residential right here, and a load of commercial, so that might be a lot better. Do we need... no, I guess we don't really need one in between, do we? We probably need to set up more bus lines, though. Yeah, we have one there, but we don't have any bus lines through this area. But I really can't be bothered. I really don't want to do bus lines. They are awful. They are the worst in the world. So we still have bloody commercial demand. Just go away. I just don't want commercial. I zoned all of that, didn't I? Yeah. Okay, we're getting a little bit of residential demand. Is anyone building a Woodland Pocket? Woodland Pocket! Come on down! Oh, okay. Well, while that's going, I'll be back in a second. I'm just going to go just over here. I'm still here, guys. Don't worry. Here we go. Alright, don't worry. I'm back, and nobody's built there. You know, it's been a tough day at work being a city planner, so, you know. Oh, okay, I didn't even open that properly. So I thought I'd grab a drink. Cheers, guys. Hang on, let me just make the sound. Cheers, guys. Bottoms up. I realize you can't see anything right now, but I was drinking a beer. Okay. Hello, it's a super long video. Lot of people dying! Oh my god, do we have enough death care? We do. I mean, we got a bunch of crematoriums around. Even, like, over there. We have, like, 5 in the area, so I think that's fine. Not gonna bother placing another one, that's fine. Just a lot of people dying. That should be fine. That's still working quite well. I think it's good that we put these roads in, because we definitely needed that. We had them all going down that way before. That was an issue. Okay, so... we got more commercial demand. Nobody built in Woodland Pocket that entire time. Where did they build then? Oh, we still have room in there, so I guess they're probably preferring to build in there first. And why is this not zoned? There we go. Get some. They'll definitely want to build there. That's the park, so I don't want to build in the park at all. I'm just looking for any other areas that could be really good for commercial to spring up. Like, I mean, like that area there. Like, why is that not zoned? There's often, you go through this and you often find... I originally did this because we had loads of traffic there, but I don't think we do anymore. I think we could probably just connect that road up normally and zone it. I mean, there's barely any traffic going there, so maybe we will. Seems like we don't need it to be like that anymore. I don't remember the original reason. I'm still going to do a one-way exit, though, I think. We'll still do one-way exit. But that just gives us more room to zone down here, so we'll fill that in. Because that'll be good. Some prime real estate on the knob! Actually, no, the knob's over here, isn't it? Yeah, that's the knob. This is like the sub-knob. Sub-knob. So dumb. No, that's good. There's a few little pockets here and there, though, like that. That's not zoned. Oh, look at all this. Look at this prime real estate. Get in there, guys. Get in there. I don't want to zone a roundabout. We still have, like, I mean, we still have this area. I could totally zone in here. I don't know if I want to... do I want to connect up the highway? Like, connect this highway up to there? I mean, it makes sense. Like, I can understand why people want me to do that, and I can understand it does make sense, but I don't think we really need to. I mean, I really don't like this road there, though, so maybe it would make a little bit of sense to do that. All right, no, let's do it. Let's do a little bit of road infrastructure design. So instead of doing that, this is going to have to go pretty much directly over. Yeah, we'll replace those roads in a minute. Gonna have to go directly over that industrial area and hopefully not cause too much destruction. But it will. Like, I'm guaranteeing you, it will create a lot of destruction. Straight across to there. Actually, is that still too high? Because I want to bring it down. It doesn't need to be too high. It only needs to be one high. Yeah, so we'll go down to there. And of course, we'll just build the other road as well. at the same spacing. Yeah, it's good. Beautiful bridge. Of course, I'll flip it around in a moment. Now, this is going to have to go right across and demolish everything in its pathway, which is really annoying. I wish I could just... Actually, if it is too high, can it just go straight over? Because that might actually be a smart idea, if that works. I don't know if you can actually do that. Like, if we go over... It does... Like, it's leaving that guy... It's only demolishing those because it's doing pillars. So, if we go to there, make it float... It only demolishes a couple of them, which is good. So, and then someone else could build there, because they definitely would be able to. So then we could go... Well, actually, let's build the other one first. Let's build this. Build the other bridge. Go straight across. Make sure it's the same spacing of the bridge. It looks good. I could get the right angle so I can see what I'm doing. There we go. And then we're going to go float it. Float tokens it straight across. So yeah, it does dezone a little bit, but I think, is that still zonable? No, it's not at all. Okay, well, no, that's all right. A little bit of dezoning. I wonder if we could get a park under there or something. Is that possible? Like, will it let me? Okay, well, let's get a sizable park that will actually fit. How about Avenue Park? Because it's for the Avenue, idiot. No, it just won't let me put anything under there. But that's fine. Like, we only destroyed a little bit. Those guys are still there. I think that'll be fine. So let's go road. Now this is going to go... down this way. Obviously, let's go down. We'll go down one. And then eventually make our way down two. Let's go straight along to there. So we'll obviously remove part of that road. Straight along. Then this one is actually going to have to go... Not like that, but we will reconnect all this up in a minute. Straight along to here. How did I do this? I guess to there, and then I went around the corner. Oh, that's pretty good. Flip, flip, flip. Flippity floop. Now, actually, this is going to be... Oh, okay, well, the bridge disappeared when I did that, so that's good. I also just realized this is going to be an issue because we need to connect it to this, but we've... Why then? Oh, because it's floating. Of course. It's like, why are there no pillars? It's because they're selected for there not to be pillars. There we go. Yeah, because we can't do roads here now because we've got the bridge there. So they might actually have to go to inward connections. So these guys need to get down, but they can't. Okay, no, we're going to have to change this. We're going to have to change that. It can't be those bridges. It needs to at least be to that point. And, oh, God. Looks kind of weird having one suspension part of the bridge, but... It's just kind of what we have to do, really, if we want this to still work. Well, if it would even work... No, good. Okay. It's gonna be annoying, isn't it? It's gonna be annoying. Because that's where it did go from. Oh, that works. Okay, that's fine. Can we do a similar thing from there? No, if you, like, curve the correct way, it would actually work. There you go, see, like that. And then we just flip it. There you go, and it didn't distort the roads too much. I just wish we could have a longer suspension bridge. Maybe we could do it. No, I guess that'll be fine. And then we'll still connect up this road, but obviously it's going to go underneath. It probably... I don't think we'll do any entrances on this to the highway. I don't know what impacts that's going to have, though, actually. Now, I don't... I want to try and avoid creating a bridge down there, because I don't think it'll look very nice. So that still connects over that way to the rest of the city. There's no entrances, though. Maybe we could do... the inner entrances. So, like, we could go, if we wanted, have it come through here. Well, in a place that can actually fit through. And then it would go, like, up to there. No, we wouldn't, because it does not work. Well, what if we go through here? Like this, and then it could connect over here. Oh, my God. Pillars. What? Really? How is that space already occupied? Ugh. Okay, let's go from this way. So then... No, that doesn't want to work. Really? Really? God damn it. Okay, well... My dream of a beautiful entrance and exit on the inside of the roundabout doesn't seem to want to come true, so, you know. Oh, well, this works. So we can have an exit. Don't know how the hell we're going to fit an entrance on, though. So, I mean, ideally we'd do the same thing going that way, but there's not enough room for that at all. Unless there is. Unless there is. Go away. Maybe we build that afterwards. No. Floating, because that will solve a lot of problems. Wait, what am I trying to do? So this is supposed to be joining to it. So yeah, going this way is fine. What do you mean space already occupied? By what? I'm just building a floating road. Stop being so angry about it. There, and then down. Down? No. Alright, well, I thought that would have been a cool idea. Unless we can just connect it in here. Like, what if we don't even bother doing two separate roads and just do a two-way straight up? Just like that. And that's it. That's how it connects. I mean, it's not ideal, and I would have to slow down quite a bit, but if that works, I'm all down for it. There you go. Well, that works. I can go up that way now. So, okay, so, I should probably connect all this back up before everybody gets really angry. Okay, so this needs to go over to that highway. And then this also needs to go there, like, in case I want to turn around. I don't think we really need the turnaround anymore, though. I think that's kind of useless. Might as well just make this a whole highway now. Because if they're turning around, they shouldn't be going that way. But this definitely needs to go above and go across. So let's actually just redesign some of this so we have enough room. That's going to go boop. And then we're going to go up. I should probably put the pillars back. I don't always want my highways floating. Okay, that's fine. Then if they wanted to keep going this way, they could get back into the area quite easily. There you go, so that's fine. That's all they need to do. We did used to have a turnaround here, but I don't think that's really necessary. So, oh, look, there's already people using this. There's no... I don't know why there would be. We don't have any entrance to the area. I guess we shouldn't we? Because now that this is actually an accessible highway, there'd be no reason for anyone to drive this direction. Although they are, but I think that was just leftover traffic, maybe. Unless it's a quicker way to get over there for some reason. I don't know. A lot of people are using this, though. Which is good, but as long as that doesn't back up, then I'm going to have to change that. Okay, what we should do, I think we can do a very easy entrance. Straight onto there. So if we go up and over. Okay, to there and then... Or not. There we go, like that. Then we should definitely do one over this side. We could go underneath. I was going to say we can't go underneath, but we can. If we go all the way around, we can go underneath here. Oh, no, there's a train line. Oh, no, there's an obvious train line right in the way. Never mind, can't go underneath. We'll have to go over. That's fine. So if we go from... Can we go there? No. Okay, let's go back further. There, and then... No, this is going to have to float. Otherwise, it's going to create a lot of problems if I don't float it. You go floaty, floaty, floaty McFloat float face. Oh wow, that's very low, but if it fits, it fits. Well, I mean, it doesn't fit, so obviously that's too low. Why does that not fit though? Like, is it just because it's being a troll, or there's a troll in the dungeon? I don't want to go all the way out over there. That's ridiculous. Really? Why can't I just go in this area? It's not high enough above the ground. Well, that works, doesn't it? Hang on. Stupid thing. No, it doesn't. Like, even though it's blue, it's not high enough. It needs to go all the way up. Okay, it needs to go up higher. We need to go up two. Unless that works. Oh, that does. What? I don't know. Okay, no. Go there and then down, I guess. No. Definitely doesn't want to start going down yet. There. Not ideal, but it works. Okay, so they have a couple of entrances there, so it's actually a useful highway. We should definitely add an entrance over here, or somewhere further on, because currently the only way to get on going that way, and it wouldn't be very useful for these guys, is to go all the way down to the end and go over that way. So if we can do one over this side, Is this all one way? No, it's definitely two way. Okay, so that's fine. If we can get an entrance around here somewhere. Like, can we just go, like, straight up? It's quite steep, but that'd be good. No, it was not going to let me. Are you sure? Oh, no, that works. Like, we could do one there. Maybe some people actually use it. That guy, he knows what's up. Because at the moment, they're still preferring the bridges just because it would have been quicker than going all the way around and onto the highway. But now a lot of more people are using that, so that's actually good. That's good. There's no quick entrance to get onto this road, though, so maybe we could do it from this way. Like that. It does remove quite a bit of our zoning, but really, we don't need that much. How's this going? Oh, they're building! That guy's going to have no power! I was just looking, because we have a little bit of residential demand. He's going to have no power, though. So, I'm going to have to give him power. Which is okay for now, but why did that go up? I thought I'd moved it down. Actually, wasn't there some power lines over here that I needed to get rid of at some point? Like the ones that went all the way around. Let's have a look. And the ones that went into the city. Yeah, they don't need it all into the town. Pause. Hang on. Is that connected? No, it's not. That's connected there, though. That's going to go to there. Then we're going to get rid of these ones. Now, Death Road is going to be a little bit out of power. But actually, no, instead of doing that, let's just get one of these. Little power relay station. There you go. Beautiful. Yeah, that connects it. Okay. Still lots of abandonment out there. We don't have enough people to work. We need to wait for more people to arrive. The overpass is working quite nicely. They still do a little bit of a sharp turn. I wish they would just go like straight in, but it's just not how it works. Woodlington is a very nice place. 5,800 people live here. Oh my god. That's incredible. That's an amazing little town. Okay, back over here though. How's my little woodland pocket? It's coming along nicely. Actually, yeah. Oh, no, that connects up over there now. Good. Yes. I was going to say, we're probably going to always need those power lines, but we don't because it connects up to the train station. Oh, this is great. Like, as if you wouldn't want to live there. Like, I mean, to be fair, yes, it is. It does have an industrial area and an industrial train station next door, but the big but is that it's a little suburban pocket right in the heart of downtown, essentially. It's a little bit out of downtown, but you know. It's all good. Few people using this. Not a lot of people using the highway. There's quite a few people, I guess, but it is working. That road underneath is not backed up, but people do use this road to get around, which is also nice, which makes me want to fill out this area a little bit. So if we're going to get more commercial demand, and we are right now. Actually, I wonder if we can get... if we can connect this to Woodland Pocket. Oh my god. Revelation. Connect it to Woodland Pocket. Yes. Yes! So good. No, that's good. I don't want to do anything on that road there, though, because otherwise it'll reveal the train line, so let's not do that. But we can do commercial around here. Now, do I want to do high density? Probably not. So, not so much in this area, I don't think. I think we'll do low density around here. So, let's get a little grass line road. So, it'd be a nice little... Nice little area. We'll just do one connection there. There's going to be low density around here. All back there as well. This is low density commercial to fulfill the need a little bit. We probably need some parks around here. Or at least Woodland Pocket does. So we can go... I need a small park. No, but that's going to reveal the train... I don't want to reveal the train station though. So I think I'm going to have to reveal it. Let's reveal it. Oh, see, that's not good. You can't really see the train station. You can just see the train line. I guess we could probably fit trees in there actually. We can actually, that's fine. There you go. I wonder how many trees we have on this map, because there is a hard limit of, I believe, 1 million trees. And when we hit that, it will tell us that we have too many trees. But I don't know, obviously we don't have too many trees. There you go, that's not so bad. You can see the train line a little bit, but it's not so bad. Let's have a look at noise pollution in the area. That's actually not bad. I mean, that guy's getting a little bit of noise, but those guys are fine. They're between a highway, industrial area, and an industrial train station. And that's pretty good. That's pretty quiet. That's pretty good. And they're also opposite. No, they're not directly opposite the oil industry, sorry. There's a little bit away. It's all good. They can also now go this way. So that's filling up. We can probably get rid of this power line driving straight through there. Actually, does that connect anywhere else? It does connect over there. So maybe we'll just get rid of this one because it's kind of ugly going across the water. Because it actually connects all down over there. And this actually connects up that way too. Oh, we could actually, yeah, let's get rid of that because this should just connect there, really. That's kind of ugly too. Get rid of that. Don't need it. Oh, maybe we did need it. Wait, that's disconnected the entire... Oh, that's how we feed the city power. That one connection we deleted here actually fed the entire city the rest of the power. Okay, well, that's fair enough. I was like, that one did everything? No, it's because we deleted the one crucial power line in the entire city. But we might actually change it to maybe over here because it's a little bit closer. Is it not? Like, could we not go... We can go straight across there. Like, that would work. And that would repower the entire city. There goes the power. Sorry about that, guys. Mayor had a little bit of a whoopsie-daisy. That's what we call it here in the mayor's office. So that goes across there. Maybe we'll do another one for safety. I do one over here. How's that? We'll have a look at the thing in a section. Thing in a section? Thing in a second. And by thing, I mean the garbage dump. That's right. So that'll connect up there as well. Still 5%. Wasn't that 5% before or was it 6? I don't know. Still 5% though. It's getting there. It is getting there. Let's have a look. Where are the trucks? 0 out of 15 trucks are in use. Well, brilliant. Stop emptying. Start emptying. Drive out. There we go. He's got 0 load. Okay, returning to facility as well. Good. Well, how can we have... 5% full and I'm emptying. Maybe, okay, why don't... What I should have done a long time ago is just do this. There we go. Come on. Get a garbage burning facility right next door. How about that? These guys are leaving, but where are you going? They've got no load on them. They're just returning to facility. They're leaving and they're returning straight away. 5 trucks are in use. It is 3% full. Oh, there we go. Can you guys just go in there, though? Because that's actually... right next door. So, nobody wants to go there. They're trying to find a way to U-turn. I think they're just gonna... Oh no, they're going that way. All right, I thought they're just gonna go around the block. Landfill site, returning to facility. It just keeps saying returning to facility. Although we are down 2%, so that seemed to have done something. It's almost empty. It's all good. So we can almost redevelop that area. Oh, Woodland Park. Pocket, not park, Woodland Pocket. Absolutely fantastic. I like that. We can also zone this little area there that we missed. I guess we should actually zone back here too, right? What we could do, because the highway actually raises up, so we could sneak underneath if we wanted. I thought it would be nice, but there wasn't any good way to do it. If we go, hang on, and then go straight out. Oh, there's like a pillar right there. See, I would rather join up over there, but I don't think... That's going to be very good. Because we can go through, but it's not ideal. No, we won't do that. We won't connect it through. I think this will be fine. We could do a pedestrian path for sure, though. If people want to walk through. Like, we can go from there to there, and then... No, stop snapping. To there. There you go. Then they can walk through. If they want to. I don't know if they will, but they can. So that's all good. Alright, so that's kind of useful. That means these guys can just drive down the road, get it straight over there. They don't have to, because otherwise, yeah, before they would have to go all the way around. That would be really inconvenient. But now they can just go straight across. Fantastic. Yeah, no, this highway is not getting a lot of use. But that's fine. I think it makes a little bit of sense. It's a good suggestion, nonetheless. I seem to have dug a hole over there at some point and left it. I think I remember doing that too. Because that was before I knew how to use the terrain tool, obviously. There you go. And let's also smooth that out. A little smidge. There you go. Good as new. No hole in the terrain anymore. Ah, that's good. It's all good. So we have a little bit more residential demand, actually. I don't know where else I want them to live. I guess probably around here somewhere. Oh, we did want to build suburbs around here too, didn't we? That was like our bounding road for suburbs. So I guess all through here is going to be some suburban areas. What I do want to do, is not Sing. But get these trees. Are those the small ones? No, these are the small ones. Let's get the small ones because it actually ends up being less dense with the small trees. Yeah, they're like that. I'm going to get like a little woodland barrier between them and the highway. I've just removed most of it, so let's do that again. Just there, because I don't want... Yeah, I don't want them seeing the highway. I mean, you can see it through there, but it won't be as bad as having it right on your back doorstep, so... This is going to go, like... No, it can be a little bit closer. There we go, just next to the tree line there. And that's not going to connect to the road there, otherwise it's going to be another intersection I don't really want to deal with. That's going to connect up here, I think. Yeah. That right in there. That can for some reason go in that way a little bit. This probably should connect somewhere here, but I don't know. I guess not. No, it won't. It'll just go around. It won't connect up to the highway or anything. Definitely not. It's a bad idea. I'll go like that. Then we can get in a giant park. About there. Oh, you beauty. What a good fit. Snug as a bug in a rug. How about that? Okay, this is going to go... This whole area is going to be residential. That's actually perfect. That's exactly how I wanted it to be. Does that have water? No. I thought I did water pipes in this area, but I think it was the other area that I did it all in. Straight up and straight down. There you go, guys. Move on in. And we'll do low density commercial on this side of the road too. Because this is that is our bounding line. So we'll have all tall buildings there. Then this will be all suburban areas now. That's sort of the edge of Knob City there. And then this is Knob Suburbs. Good. I mean, I guess we could have used this as a main road going straight across. But I don't think I really want to do that. I think we'll... This will be... This whole area will just be connected to that road there. I think that'll be fine. Is anyone actually building here? Oh yeah, there's like a dude building there. That's fine. I guess what we should do is... someone has already built there. So let's go this way. Let's connect those two roads. And then actually I'm going to go... I guess through there because nobody's going to build here anyways. Like that. So they can walk through. It's all good. And this actually might go this way a little bit. There you go. So they can walk around. And then we should probably think about subway station in here. That's probably a good idea because this is kind of like the main road in this suburban area, I think. So I think what we'll do, I'm going to keep saying I think a few more times. Let's put that in there. Chuck on a new station. Because that was always the plan with this line, is to get more stations in the area as we build it up over time. So then we're going to go line, green, out of stop. Yellow, out of stop. There you go. Obviously, it's not going to be powered right now, but when it is, it'll be all good. And then, this is good. So we've got 179,000 people, which is not actually that much considering how big our city is. But I guess most of our city is actually suburbs. Like, all around here is suburbs. All of that is suburbs. Pretty much, all Vast Friends and around this is going to be suburbs as well. So it's not supposed to be a high-density, high-packed city. It's all good. All good in the hood. How's this working? Do they get in the way of people coming out? Well, I don't know now because I've just missed it. Did that guy just despawn before he got in there? Maybe, I don't know. But that one's fine. Still not enough workers. Where's everyone coming from? How far away do people come from? They're coming from Smallville, from the other farms to these farms. It's interesting. Huh. Well, there you go. How's Woodland Pocket? Whoops. It's a nice little place. This guy does not have a very nice house, though, but... Oh, no, maybe he's upgrading. He's finally decided, my house is crap. I'm getting a better house. And that he is. Let's see. The big reveal. Oh, this guy's got a car. This guy has got a car. Oh, lady, sorry. This gal has got a car. Beautiful house, Annabelle. Very nice. Much better than before. Very nice skyline view from here, actually. Look at that. That's very nice. You get the little suburb in the front and you get the city in the back. How good is that? That's cool. Oh, look. There's Silicon Hill in the distance. Got all your planes up in the air. This game is actually beautiful, though. So good. Look at this place. We built all this. We built this entire thing. So if we go to the one end of the city, we cannot actually see the other side of it. We physically cannot see the other side of the city. Same. So if we look from here, oh, we can just see Silicon Hilly up over there in that corner. Just, it's so foggy, but there it is. Let's have a look at the canals. Look at this. I don't like all those buildings there, though. They look absolutely awful because it's the same building. But that's the way it is, I guess. Oh, this is really good. Okay, so we need some more commercial. God damn it, why do they always want commercial? We want commercial. Give us more commercial. Alright, guys, fine, I will. Jesus. Stop complaining! Go down this road, because this will be commercial anyways. There you go. Just build there. Stop complaining. It's a beautiful road. Like, nobody driving on it. It's a 6-lane road. It used to be busy. Not anymore. Let's have a look. Where was our major problem? How's this going, by the way? That's all fine. Oh, that guy has no water. Sorry, buddy. There you go. Oh, yeah, sorry. We should probably fill in this little area with the commercial as well. Do I want to get another road in there? I guess so. If we just go straight up, that'll probably be fine. Just do that. I mean, it's not ideal, but that'll do. So it'll got water? No, it doesn't. Oh, no, it's not power. It does have water, though. Well, I might as well connect it down to there as well. Okay. No, okay. So this is going to be commercial. Might as well just paint it, actually. Probably be easier. Don't want them on the water side, though. So just there. I mean, I guess we could fit someone there, but not going to do it now. That's all good. So, oh, look at this. Yeah, look at this Riverside Road. That's a really nice road, though. Very nice. It would be even nicer if there wasn't an industrial area on the other side of it. But, you know, can't have it all. And then we have this tangled bowl of spaghetti over here that you have to somehow navigate. And somehow get to the other side of. Well, it's okay if you're staying on the same highway, but as soon as you want to turn, like, if you're trying to go left, you actually have to go right, loop around, go over and over that way. But, that's all good. We don't actually have any exits here, though. In this area. I don't want to think about adding them either, because that'll be a mess. Oh, look at this. So many people exiting there. This, I think, is one of my favorite interchanges we built during the episode. Like, I mean, I do love a good turbine, but I built that in the acid editor, not actually during a video. I think that's pretty cool. This one actually looks nice. And it kind of works. I'm not quite sure why they're stopping. Oh, we actually do have traffic lights there? That's probably why. There weren't supposed to be traffic lights there, so I'm going to get rid of those. Just keep going. Should be fine. Should be all good. Oh, so this is all filled out. That was all commercial, wasn't it? That filled out. Why does that get, like... So look at the wall of this building as we zoom out. It's like super blue for some reason. I don't know. Okay, so we have a lot of commercial demand. But, you know, it's been 2 hours and almost 20 minutes. So I think I'm going to leave this part here. Part 50. By far our longest episode in the series. But, you know, you guys earned it. You helped continue the series on for 50 parts due to your diligent viewing. And support of the series, that's for sure. So that's all good. But I think what we'll do, we need to find somewhere someone driving somewhere. Someone new, I guess. Actually, let's go over here. Let's find someone. We need someone leaving the area, though, don't we? So we need someone that's leaving. Maybe this guy. Where are you off to? Delivering products to Juice Press. Oh, well, that's pathetic. Okay, let's not go there. That's going absolutely nowhere. To Beefcakes. Oh, he's going to Smallville. That's going to be a boring drive, though. It's just along the highway. We really need to go in the city somewhere. That's not going to track. I have a garbage truck. Collecting garbage. Load 2%. Well, where is he going? Let's find out where the garbage truck is off to. But yeah, you supported it for 50 episodes, and here we are, number 50. I wonder if you've watched this in one sitting. Well done, first of all. Because playing this in one sitting was very easy. It's definitely easier to play the game in one sitting than it is probably to find 2 hours and 20 minutes to sit and watch it. But that's fine. You know, I guess ideally I probably should have posted this episode on a weekend, but that's just not the way I roll. It's also going to take me forever to upload this, so that'll be fun. so yeah. But yeah, now we're going for a drive through the city. Where the hell are we? I don't know. Oh, okay. There's There's Hawthorne over the other side of the water. All right. I don't know. We're just going around collecting garbage. So we got 16%. We haven't stopped. So this is how garbage trucks work, apparently. Let's keep driving. Collecting garbage, collecting, collecting. Returning to facility. Incineration plant. Don't know which one this lives at, so we'll find out. That's an incredibly... I wish garbage trucks were this efficient in real life. How amazing would that be? They don't even have to stop. You would never, ever get stuck behind a garbage truck again. Ever. You would just keep driving. I don't know where the hell we are either. Oh, we're back at the water, so... Oh, is that the new town over there? I think that's our new town that we built. What was it? Whatever it was called. Woodland something. Woodlington. I think that was the new town that we saw across the water. So this is going... I guess we're going back to the highway, are we? Yep. Which incineration plant is this going to, though? Because I thought we moved them all to the one place over in the new industrial area. I mean, obviously not, because that's not where we're going. I don't know. Where is this? So we're taking an exit. I have no idea. Maybe we missed one. Let's find out together. So we're back over here. Nope. Yeah, so we're heading towards Smallville at the moment. It's kind of the direction we're headed. Now we're taking an exit. What the hell road is this? Oh, this goes up to Wineglass, doesn't it? Wineglass Hills, which we never got around to redeveloping this episode, but we will get around to that. Because it's an awful area. It's an awful, awful area. So we need to fix that up one day. So apparently we still have garbage incineration out here, I guess. I mean, we must do, right? Right? If I could speak properly. Bit of speed there. Speed. And slow down. Because these roads are slow. Oh, and speed! Ooh! So fast. Okay, so where is this place? Is that it on our right? Coming up? I don't know what that looks like from ground level. It must be one of these, right? Over here. Here we go. Alright, so yeah, he drove up this way. On the speed road, and then so we have garbage incineration right there. How about that? Should probably, yeah, we have a bunch there actually. Should probably move that. No, I guess I don't want to move all of them down here, but we have a lot of them down here. Oh yeah, is that empty in the port? Heyo, it's finally empty. You can go away. You go bye bye now, and you also go. So this is now ready for redevelopment in the port. Leave in the comments down below what we should redevelop the port into. Should it be all commercial? I really don't want it to be, so let's not do that. Should it be just a suburb? Should it be high-end residential? I don't know. If you got any cool ideas, let me know. It's a blank canvas right in the middle of our city. So that's really, really cool. But thanks for watching, guys. If you watched this in one sitting, well done. If you didn't, either way, well done, because you made it to the end. Thank you very much. I will see you next time, and have an awesome day.